Turn him down too, bro.
You feel me? Come on. Come on, I'm representing for the two. And no, y'all know how we do things. Y'all know I'm representing the H in this motherfucker. I'm plugged in this bitch. Holla that. You ready?
Let's go. Ace of Freak. Hey, yo, my mans is here, son. You heard him? You heard him, though?
Come on, now. I'm slow, loud, and banging all in my trunk. You feel me?
Oh, fuck. I know where this is going. Look, you got topics?
I will have some topics.
That means no. To answer your question, he does not have topics.
I will have topics. Hey, y'all heard about OnlyFans allowing explicit content back on their platform? Like, bro,
we're not
what?
Yet. We're not starting yet. We're not starting yet.
Yo, this shit crazy.
Keep it.
What's so crazy about the topic?
Hey, because we had a prior conversation about it.
Yeah. So,
and Asa swore that they would be fine without it, and they were out. They canceled it like for like a week. I think it was a week.
Yeah.
And they was like, "Oh no, we need the sex backs because we ain't making enough money."
They need. They were trying to get mainstream investors, and so right now, I think it will eventually go away. But I think moving so fast,
work just to wait, the detriment. Bro, wait. Put it on the podcast.
No. I'm gonna say the same thing, but like,
wait. Let me start. We recording, right? E, we recording. We recording.
Yeah, the red button is
pushed. Elliot.
The red button is pushed.
All right, hold on, Ace. Let me start with the fucking song. Damn,
let me get some liquor real quick in my system.
Yo, my left foot about to come off.
Hold on. What did you say you wanted to hear? You still want to hear the whistle song?
Left foot.
We could do it.
Shout out to the whisper song. You know what I'm talking about?
Hey, Eddie, can you give me a whiskey?
Eddie, your left foot.
Hey, how you doing, love mama? Let me whisper in your ear.
All right, bro. Whisper sour.
Don't even worry about that
shit, y'all. I got you.
Mind if I touch it and see if it's soft.
Now I'm just being like a fight cake rules and doing push-ups every day.
Yeah, what are you doing?
Asa, you gotta shut the fuck up. Hey. That's how Gigi was. Hey, your left foot, dog. Stop doing that. You didn't even fucking wait. Give me a look at you or nothing.
Hey, damn. Give me some whiskey. You got let's see, got Tennessee honey or no? Yeah, give me a Tennessee honey, some ice. All right, well, give me some Tennessee honey.
Hey, look,
Tennessee honey.
Hey, Asa, sit your ass.
Please. Why you sit like that?
You wanna buy?
Huh?
Get it the fuck together.
Hey, yo, let me give you some props though. The hair look amazing.
I ain't buying no dog right now. My dog.
Real talk.
That shit look incredible. Right, I got a King Corso. Not that. I don't want that.
Damn it. It's been that long. We rusty than a motherfucking hair. It's been that long.
Come on, now. Talk to me. Talk to your shit.
I think it's stuck. Eddie, I
told you not to hit that.
That nigga stuck. That nigga stuck.
Yo. Yeah, I can hear me loud and clear, my nigga. I'm back.
I can hear you, nigga.
It's your boy Big Honcho. You know what?
Not the little one, huh?
My nigga. Hey, we gonna get to that. Holiday to my left. We got Asa Big Breezy to my left. I got JT in the Astro looking swaggy.
Come on.
We got a newbie in the house. Legend. We got Lamont Hills in the building, guys. And you know we got ET across from me. Hand my man
Feeling good. Feeling good. Drop my thing.
Why you sound like a grandpa?
You about to get the drink drop.
And of course, where grinding never stops, Mr. Elliot Mills behind the ones and twos. Almost played Blame It on the Juice.
Yeah, you fuck it up.
First of all, health and wealth. How's everybody mental? Holiday, let's start with you.
Good, man. Real good.
You all right, man? Nothing going on?
Nothing going on, you know.
What? Stop the cap.
Oh, my God. How's it Cap?
I'm calling Cap right now because he got some big stuff going on.
What do you got going on, Aza?
Where'd you just come from, Holiday? Let's not cap to the audience now.
Where you just came from, Holiday?
Just got done holding it down for my nigga OJ Harwell. Fresh Pro debut.
Yes, sir.
Big sponsor, Holiday
Lynch. When's the date? When's the date? When's
September 25th. Gonna be in Floresville.
Come on.
Okay. Check it out. We got the flyer on my Instagram, all that. Holla at me.
Yes, sir. September 25th.
Okay.
Hey, we gotta stop not talking about our accomplishments. You feel me?
Talk your shit, Asa.
We gotta stop doing that.
That's
bro.
Facts.
You know what I mean? Like, this is every a big step for you.
Every time we come in here, y'all talking about some nothing.
Nothing's going on.
I'm good.
I'm finna get my. Where's my fucking guitar? I'm finna get my. Asa,
what's been going on with you, man?
Man, y'all already know what it is. I'm not big honcho, but, you know, I'm getting to that level of big honcho status, you feel me? So,
respect.
One of the things that I got going on right now is, of course, the job. And outside the job, and I got the camera studio and stuff like that. So, you might see me coming out with maybe a podcast.
Okay, the Asia Show.
Maybe.
Tune in. It's going to be on the Where Grinding Never Stops Network.
You know, black entertainment, but we're going to keep it kind of classy.
Jabbar. Why you always hating, bro? Let that man shine, bro.
Yo, you feel me, bro?
It's not about
Jabbar,
him.
How are you, bro? How
I was
you?
Good.
You was good?
I was good. No, I'm good, bro. I'm good. Everything Gucci in my life, bro.
Nothing new?
More life.
Word life. What's up, Lamont? Welcome back home, dog.
Come on, dog.
Not necessarily any circumstances, but you know, it feels good nonetheless.
I could feel it. Prayers out to everyone that has to deal with Hurricane Ida. Our thoughts are out to y'all. Safety is the number one priority at that moment. I hope most of y'all evacuated. My mans came home because of it, so let's just keep our prayers for them. Eddie?
Yo.
Why are you so fucking relaxed?
I'm chilling, baby.
That nigga. That nigga's
good.
Tough.
Feeling blessed. CT Eddie never stress.
Bro.
Niggas acting brand new today. We get a new environment. Hey, shout out to the environment we are in.
Come on.
My man Ramon and Aaliyah's house, humble abode.
Come on, man.
As you can see, the beauty.
The sheer art.
And let me shout out Ramon, my
of
boy.
Course,
it's his birthday.
Come on.
Happy birthday, Ramon.
I think he's big 35. Yes, y'all give it up for him.
He in the back doing what he do.
He's not 35.
Big 2'8".
Oh, okay. He's a big 2'8". He's a solid 2'8". My bad. But yeah, nonetheless, shout out to him. He's doing this thing. He's going to get married. He's about to have a son.
Come on.
Big props to him. He's doing it big. A mentor of mine, a friend. You know, we all go way back, but you know what I'm saying? He's doing it on a different level, man. Working directly with me, helping me grow into the person I need to become. So let's load the gun, let's cock the whip, you know what I'm saying? Because we coming for everybody in this motherfucker. Right.
Talk your shit, son. All right.
We finna be the best.
Hey,
shout out,
load the gun and cock the whip. You know what I'm saying?
He cock and whip.
The man with the plan. The man with the plan.
That sounds like it hurt. I don't want to cock no whips. All right, man.
We gotta address this situation. Why don't you like cracking the whip? You don't use it on your shawty?
You didn't say cracking.
You said cocking.
You know.
So let's ask the most important questions. Y'all don't use whips. I mean, we're not about to change subjects until y'all answer the question.
Do we not? What? What's the question?
I know the time is to pull out a whip and just spank carpet.
Yeah, but are you opposed to it? What about the handcuffs?
Oh, that's definitely.
What is this right now?
I don't know what we're doing.
I'm genuinely curious. You know what I'm saying?
You curious what he be doing?
I think he's asking everybody open-ended.
No, he looking dead in your eyes.
I'm really going.
I'm gonna ask you next, Jovan. Don't worry.
Don't worry, Jovan.
Jovan, are you opposed to using whips?
You're next.
And are you opposed to using handcuffs?
I'm a virgin, bro.
You have a
Jovan, you're 6'4", right, shout out to the version.
Your son's right there.
I adopted him.
Jovan.
I'm looking at your son.
I adopted.
Play that for me.
He's adopted. He's adopted.
That's so crazy. I'll take that as a yes, since he wants not to answer the question. Holiday, what do you say? Are you opposed to using whips and handcuffs?
Hey, yo. What is going on here?
Don't worry, I'll get to you next.
You're not getting to me. Holiday.
Holiday.
Hey, I plead the fifth, dog. I plead the fifth.
Oh, shit. Eddie, I know you nasty as motherfucker.
But I ain't cracking no whips. I'm cracking fists.
You about to fist?
No, wait.
What?
What?
That nigga sounds crazy.
And see? And it goes there.
I mean, Eddie, if you fisting, I mean, I need to get some pointers because...
Why are you
we don't call you E.T. for no reason. You feel me?
What's up, E.T.?
Why
do
you call you E.T., Eddie?
Because we was going to the next subject. Ayo, you were saying...
Ayo, you was talking about...
I was talking about the weather and shit.
Come on.
Okay.
Hey, I'm not going to lie to you. I want to talk about some real shit real fast.
What's up, big dog?
It's finally settling in that I'm about to be a father.
Come on.
Oh, come on now.
That shit mad weird.
What happened to make it settle in?
I ain't going to lie, bro. For a while, I've been saying that little nigga don't like me. Because every time Kenya says, oh, he's kicking, he's punching, I put my hand on his stomach, I don't feel shit. The nigga don't like me. So, for the first time, bro, I felt the nigga box my hand up, and I gave him a couple of nudges back, and it hit my heart.
You gave him some nudges back?
Oh, yeah. You ain't gonna come out bitching me. You got me fucked up. Had to put my hands over early.
You hit him.
But yeah, man, that shit kicking in.
That's what I'll get.
So were handcuffs and whips used to
conceive? Oh, my God. Anyway. So, yeah. Shout out to him. When's the date? What's the month? I'm sorry. I ain't trying to give all that details out. But what's
November, man. November.
November.
Oh, right around the corner.
Right around the corner. November.
And then the birthday boy right behind us.
Come on, now.
The birthday boy right behind us.
Come on.
We go definitely keep it, you know, kind of classy since this is his abode. So, you know, just respect, you know.
What is he talking about? Bro, this is what he's talking about.
Look, I was just saying, you know what I'm saying? I'm just going to keep it kind of
shut
wraps,
your ass
you
up.
Saying?
Any tips as successful young black fathers, Holiday, Jovan, Eddie, any tips you got for me, dog?
Beat their ass.
Oh, yeah.
Wait, that's early.
Beat their ass.
That's early, though.
Nah, but honestly, just cherish the moments, bro. Like, they get, I mean, my son finna turn 4 September 13th. So, I mean, and I'm like, 4? My daughter just started school. I'm like, damn, this is going by quickly. And your mom's gonna tell you that, go by quick. Yeah. But you just like, all right, I hear you. And then you turn around, like, this nigga is starting school for real.
Eddie?
So, just cherish the moments.
I second that, dog. Time flies, bro. You think time going fast? Nah, just wait till your son just out here just yelling in your ear and shit. That shit gonna go by fast, dog.
That shit gonna go by quickly, bro.
Holiday, anything?
Yeah, the first couple of days gonna be a little rough with your sleep schedule, but overall, just lead by example. Lead by example.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Big.
I see. I have to tighten up a lot of my habits because of what's coming, so.
Tighten up, like, what kind of habits?
No, man, I be leaving shit on the floor and shit, you know, little shit.
Are you going to stop smoking?
Am I going to stop smoking? No.
He said, what are you going
to
do that
no,
for?
Sir, but I do have to change my smoking habits to where there's certain times where I can't, certain times where I can't. Can't smoke in the house no more.
Right.
I'm already on that regimen. Right. Can't be getting on my ass, so. Man, I'm good.
Smoke weed every day.
Not every day. Not every day.
I said it right.
But I'm good.
Anyway.
Smoke weed every day.
Where Lamar go?
Yeah, he off this. He's off this.
That man got ADHD.
Holiday.
Asa, go ahead, man. Start us off, Asa.
Come on.
It's your birthday, bro.
So... So one of the things I wanted to talk about and that took the internet by storm, as you guys probably know about, OnlyFans is now allowing sexually explicit content back on their platforms. So shout out to all the 304s, Seven Toes,
Who you shouting out, bro?
Shout out to all the 304 selling toe pictures.
You so. Hype, and you want to know why you hype? Because when we had this conversation, it was they'll be fine without it. They don't need that to make money. And now you their best friend. What's that all about?
Nah, because I just know what's to come.
He's a subscriber.
What's to come?
I just know what's to come. Wait a second. I can't give you all my secrets just up front.
You about to start an OnlyFans?
Bitch, what?
Wait a second. I wouldn't start an OnlyFans. I definitely get on Patreon, though.
Why do you know what that is? What is that?
Patreon? It's a subscription-based service to help creators further create.
Yeah.
It just sounds like some extra kinky shit.
Nah, it can be. No. It can be. You feel me?
What are you going to be doing on your Patreon?
Patreon will be like exclusive content, how to fix your credit, how to... it depends. We are literally going to be hitting on all subjects that you need to be good on as a man. So sexually, physically, mentally, getting your reading right, getting your stamina right, getting all that stuff right, because there's so much that goes into being a man that I'm still learning every single day. But what I'm going to do is compile a list of things that you need to know as a man. Not getting a loan from the car lot when you're getting a car. Don't be stupid. You know what I'm saying? Go to your bank first.
Okay. I was trying to see where you're going with that. I was like, you paying cash?
Yeah. No. You need to get that because you only want your credit ran one time. You feel me? So as you go.
But then again, I'm also hearing that while you're there, you have whatever that window is. Say you're getting your car on 23rd. Mm-hmm. You can run it a million times on the 23rd through those companies because it's only one inquiry based on the day.
Yeah, that's facts.
So I thought that doesn't matter.
At the car lot?
Yeah. Yes.
No, they run your credit multiple times.
They're going to bounce it around to other people, but
it's
one inquiry based off of that one date.
Well, it's one inquiry for them, but when you see all the hits on your credit score, then it's going to be a problem.
I mean, I have pretty good credit. I ain't got that good.
You talking this shit.
But I'm just going off a personal experience because when I went to go buy my car, I had maybe a 700 credit score and I got a 4.7% APR rate, right? So after I got my car, my credit score dropped down from like a 700, 720 to about a 600, 620. And so I'm looking at all these things on my credit report. And I'm like, bro, what is
going on? Somebody defrauding this shit. That's not normal for buying a car.
I'm about to say. You almost lost 100 points off of buying a car?
Yeah, because I ain't going to lie. Because
everybody's here about a vehicle.
But no, if you have 700, that's something going on. Because if you have 700 credit score, they're not running your shit 100 times.
Oh, no. Nah, you, but you they're running it a couple, which is enough to because it's a big purchase.
To lose a whole 100 points.
Yeah, you don't know what you're talking, you don't know what you're talking about right now.
Oh, no?
I got the bell.
I've been there, bro.
Oh, you have?
Yeah, I have.
I mean, we've all bought a car.
I have.
Okay, so but, what would you recommend young men when you're buying a car?
Wait a second.
Okay, perfect. So I'm asking you, Jomon.
Okay.
Since you've been through this process before, yes, and you disagree clearly, right? Yep. That's what it sounds like.
Yeah, because you don't lose 100 points off of two.
Yeah, he's disagreeing with what you're saying about the points.
Okay. So we're not losing 100, but would you disagree with me telling young men to go ahead and get...
Wrong. What?
No, I'm just...
So I meant that you're wrong there. I want you to admit you're wrong there.
He might have lost 100 points.
So
that's something different.
But that's something different. Yeah. But he's saying it because he ran that shit twice. Like, admit that you're wrong there, and then we can move on.
Wait a second.
No, because you're not going to do me like that.
Because it really... No, it sounds like you know exactly what my process was when I bought my car.
What was it? Was it more than just...
Was you in the back with him? With the financial direction and all that?
Yes.
No, you was not.
Bro.
Cap.
So I'm
telling you. Wait.
Guys. You're not allowed to.
Wait a second. We're going off subject now.
We're crazy. Nigga, we've been off subject.
So
the subject was what you are providing on your Patreon. Yeah, y'all right, niggas started snapping.
Yeah, because Jovan loves to prove me wrong. You know what I'm saying?
So you was wrong.
Tried to prove me wrong.
You was wrong.
So one of the things I love, one of the things I do love about this group is because we all have different minds and different how we look at things, right? So Lamont, he's a big time attorney lawyer in Louisiana, which he hopefully is moving back down to Texas.
Shout out,
right? Jovan is a huge salesperson. You know, Elliot, Ayo, and Holiday are one of the best debaters I have seen. You know, and Eddie.
if we say that's something wrong, he's going to be adamantly involved in everything, as you guys have
you
probably
bet your
seen
sweet ass I will.
Talk your shit, E.T. What? Talk your shit. So, thing I love about this group is because we're all different. Now, you guys love to argue, and I have no problem with that because I love to prove you guys wrong. And
you don't
I love
prove me wrong.
But
you, wrong. You don't prove me wrong.
Oh, wait a second. Wait
he
a second.
Probably proved me wrong.
Listen, you be wrong.
You don't prove me wrong. You don't prove me wrong, bro.
I got to do the percentages like you do.
Yeah. 93.4%.
Let's take a vote. You guys in the audience, I'm looking at you guys. What I want you guys to do is keep track of everything I say, and then I want you to go back and I want you to look it up on Google, because one of the things that these guys don't specialize in is research.
Oh shit.
What I do. So I do this. So I do this. You know what I'm saying? So look up mainly not you.
Relax, bro.
Mainly not you, Lamont. Because this is only your first day here. But for Jawan,
hey. You're upsetting my friend.
I apologize. Relax. Let me take a drink of my beer. Holiday. If you were to open up like your own business, you know, I know you're doing your camera shit and everything like that. If you were opening up a Patreon, what kind of value would you provide to men, to people, on your Patreon?
Just what I specialize in, just photography work, you know, having a creative mindset, you know, just some of that nature.
Would it be like some other kind of content to where you can have, they can actually see your day or how you set up a scene or something like that? Like, how would it be? Like, you know, explain, talk about that. Like, what would you want the people to see?
All right, yeah, just, you know, next subject, dog. Yeah.
He said, mind your business.
He don't want to give away too much, you feel me?
Before it drop.
Can't give away the codes.
Can't give before it drop.
Everybody got that video I sent, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Everyone seen it?
Yeah.
Yep. Insert video here, Elliot. Basically, I'll narrate since our viewers can't see the video. We have... It looks like Philly, a situation where the street was flooding. Drunk night about 2 a.m. This is my story now, Javon. Watch out. Drunk night about 2 a.m. Shorty said, carry me across the street. We got to go home.
Across the street.
Blah-de-blah. Blah. Yeah, they was going across the street.
She was wide,
too. No, she was not even, though.
Nah, not really.
She was definitely kind of.
Here you go, wrong again.
Can I finish what I'm doing, though?
Wrong again. Audience,
2 o'clock in the morning.
Shorty hops on her man's back. The more steps he takes, the deeper into the water he goes. And it's about back pocket waist-ish. Mm-hmm. And the knees gave out, man. There was nothing he could do about it. when you see the video, you'll see the water was way deeper than you think it is. Like, yeah. She was under the water type shit. Mm-hmm. So, fast forward to the end. They flipping, they rolling. They get to the end. He stops. He helps her up. She pushes him off and falls while she's pushing him. Some big, swole Tyrone nigga comes around the corner.
So what you want?
And he
okay, I got
and
you.
He
I got
grabs
you.
Her by the wrist and the ass cheeks, and pulls up. She wraps her legs around the man, and all three of them walk out. Let's start here. Is it his fault that she fell?
I mean, yes. It's the water.
Don't set yourself up for something you cannot follow.
I heard that too. I don't think, bro, you.
Y'all didn't have to cross that water.
Think about the moment. Think about the moment. Yes, you do.
No,
crib,
bro.
On the other side.
Y'all can. Let's play games until we hit the water.
Shorty is in your ear. This is my story now, remember? Shorty is in your ear.
Talking about nasty.
I've been wanting to go home, Lamont. Why the fuck we still out here, Lamont? Oh, it's raining, Lamont. Carry me across the street, Lamont. You tired of hearing it. You like, man, just get on my back. Fuck.
Well, I'm not going to fall. I'm talking about this.
Bruh. Yeah. Everybody saying they wouldn't fall.
I've been squatting my whole life.
The water is up to his waist.
Look.
First of all, he fucked up for having her in the back and not in the front.
Yeah, he was tweaking on that.
You definitely have to have it in the
but
front.
But you can
more
see
balance.
His knees buckling while it's happening. I can't blame him, bro. I can't blame him for that.
Which one?
For the first one. First one. No, we ain't got there yet. See, you all such it. Eddie.
He tried to do what he can do.
Thank you, bro. He said, bro, let me be Superman to my girl. Like, let me do this.
Yeah. Wait a second. Let's not look
over the fact that she looks about 200 plus pounds.
No, she don't. She looks 120 pounds, nigga.
Bro, what you talking about? My man's looking about 170, 175.
You need to see the video, bro.
I seen the video.
Why is that even important, though?
If you're wrong,
because here's the thing. If she weighs more than him, that's going
to
be tough.
Are you not supposed to be able to squat more than your body weight?
You are, so but see, at the same, wait a second, because we're getting off subject here. So, when you're in water, when we're in water, and you have another person on your back.
She looks 200 pounds?
That girl don't look 200 pounds at all.
Bro, girls carry weight in a different way than what we're used to.
Everybody else in this room?
I can see by her thighs.
Wait, what did he say?
Come on, not stretch that one marks.
Time. Just say what you said one more time.
You can't see no stretch marks in the video.
Come on, bro.
Bro, you're not even close enough to see the fucking stretch marks.
Wait a second. Jawan, are you saying you're looking at that ass?
Yeah, I'm looking at that ass right now. You can't see no stretch marks.
Damn. That's interesting.
Bro, this shit is not up to his waist, first of all.
What was it at?
This shit is...
I said back pocket.
He's not even in the water.
Yeah, he tall. His whole legs in the
that
water.
That nigga
dog.
Gave out.
And then the flow was going this way. This nigga fell this way. He's just clumsy.
Right. He probably stepped on the curb, bro. He probably stepped on the curb.
Let's get past, buddy. We get to the end of the road.
Yeah.
You finally brace yourself. You can get up. Bah, water off your face. You stand up. You help her up. Pull her up. Push that man and fall. So you know when she falls, she get extra mad. You see... the big linebacker nigga run up and come grab your girl by her ass cheeks.
Yeah, okay.
And pull out the water.
Me personally.
I'm not what you doing. Chew in your eyes.
I'm dropping that nigga. He gonna drown.
All three of us gonna be in that water.
He drowned. No. He's drowning.
No, because I'm a slipper. All three of us gonna be in that water.
You gonna super bad that nigga. Just dive at that nigga.
Bro.
Nah, mind your business, bitch. Bitch, we drown, bitch, let us go.
Eddie, how you feel?
That was stupid. I would have jumped on his back while he carried her out. And then when he put us down, then I'm knocking his ass out. Because that nigga was still struggling to get out the water. So I'm jumping on his back with him.
That's what I'm saying. He's struggling to get out the water, so I got a little advantage in the water, bro. He might buckle. I got him. And then he going to float
nigga
down the river.
Save me too.
Shit.
I think Eddie for sure drowned him.
How you feel about it, bro? How you feel about Buddy running into the water to come pick your girl up?
I would have been Buddy running in. I'm not falling.
I know you. I know you.
And I got this.
How you feel?
Y'all don't want to know how I feel.
We want to know how you feel.
Keep it on the subject, okay? We asking you one question.
Y'all want me to keep it a stack, bro?
And we don't care nothing about nobody's body weight either.
I mean, cause she not 200. You
we ain't even worried about
face.
She for sure look about 200.
Okay.
Boy, besides the fact that she's 200.
Okay, I'll give her 180 because the photo camera and video adds about 10 pounds.
Okay, cool. So that's how do you feel about the situation?
Not even realistic.
She's not 180.
Maybe in the 80s.
You already just get to your point. What's up? How you feel about it? How you feel about Buddy coming helping your girl up?
I mean, first of all, she should have been walking in the first place. Why are we putting her over our priorities? We are the prize. I don't know what he's doing, but he's tripping.
Oh, shit.
So, Wait a second.
No, I'm confused. Go back.
Hold on, real quick.
Relay.
Because if I lose track of thought, I'm not gonna come back to my
original point. Let's let him finish his thought.
So, first of all, as soon as I seen Buddy grab him, she would have been kicked out immediately.
Kicked out
because she wrapping her legs around another man.
That's a whole other subject. We didn't get there yet. We did not get there.
We didn't get there yet.
That's the next topic.
No.
That's the next topic. How do you feel about Buddy running into the water and picking your girl up? You just failed. Don't tell me I wouldn't do it. I understand. Yes, nobody in here would do it until it happens to y'all and then y'all got looking goofy than a motherfucker. But what I'm saying is, you're the man. She just pushed you, fell again in the water. You soaking wet, blah, blah, blah. How do you feel in that moment?
Well, I wouldn't feel any type of way. I would think she was for the streets. She's gone. She's dead to me.
She's dead to me.
She gotta go.
Dead to me.
Eric,
she's
dead to me. Where you get that from? She's dead to me.
Shout out to my mentor in the back. You feel me?
Come on, y'all better mentor. Stop letting him shout dead. Out loud.
Crew, let's go.
Oh, hell no.
Oh shit. Okay.
Yeah. All right, my bad. We keeping it on subject. My bad.
Anyways, because he still ain't answering my question.
Wait. Okay,
that's
my
fine.
Bad.
No, you answered it the way you wanted to answer.
Okay.
So let's
maybe you
got to
word it just a little bit different.
We'll switch to the next part of the topic.
Okay, sounds good.
He picks your girl up.
He picks her up.
She wraps her legs around Buddy.
Right, 304 activity.
How you feel about? Let me speak for myself, of course.
Okay.
That's his girl now.
Yeah, facts.
Mentally.
Facts.
Only thing I gotta do is tee off on Buddy, like right on the back.
No. First of all, we never fight over women. Don't do it.
I'm speaking for me.
Oh, yes, sir.
I'm speaking for me.
I understand completely.
So shut up.
I'm teeing off on Buddy.
Uh-huh.
Cause she should know better and he should know better.
Talk your shit.
But her situation with me is gonna be a whole lot different. Like, I don't know how that bounce back is after that. Like that, like a whole nother nigga. Like, you, I understand. I understand. I failed.
I understand you was drowning, bitch. But you
I was drowning too. I was drowning too.
Look.
But there's certain lines we not going. Come on, bro.
I don't see myself failing that mission. But if I fail that mission and I had us looking like that, I'm not mad at what you do. That's embarrassing.
It's embarrassing, but it's an accident. Bro, he didn't throw her. He didn't push her in the water. Like, come on, bro. He tried to help.
You can't get yourself out. He thought,
you don't know what the situation is.
I'm not doing that. Nothing in my brain tells me to go step into that bullshit.
What if he's drunk? What if he's high?
I don't make bad decisions when I'm drunk.
We're not speaking on you, boy. We're speaking on the situation already happened.
Why would you ask me? I'm going to put myself in his shoe.
We can't. All right.
That's facts. But I think...
How you feel?
I'm 300 Spartan kicking that nigga in the fucking back. Yeah.
In his back, she on his back.
No, she in the front. So both of them driving down the road.
See, that just pissed me off even more. She was on his front.
That's what I'm saying. Like this, saddled up motherfucker.
And
like
this nigga rubbing his meat on your shoulder. Her dress pulled up. Yeah, he grabbed her by the ass out.
Ass out.
Boy.
Oh shit.
Ass out.
That's cancel, nigga. Yo, pack your shit tonight. Who is this nigga right here?
Who is this nigga?
You know this nigga?
Oh, you have to know this nigga.
You must know this nigga.
Captain Save-A-Ho.
Know this nigga right here.
Captain Save-A-Ho. Nah, go with that nigga.
Y'all so caught up on that female. Nigga, save me. Fuck that bitch. Nigga, come get me. That's how I feel. That nigga took all the time to come save her. He could have pulled me out too.
Yo.
I'm mad about that, dog. But that's what makes me mad, because we both drowned.
Exactly.
Yeah. You came and saved her.
He saved her.
Which means you wanted to be a superhero today.
Captain Save-A-Ho.
Exactly. It's over.
Go with that hoe.
Yeah, you gotta shoot.
How does the night end?
You gotta shoot that nigga.
I'm going.
No, after y'all.
Facts.
Y'all make it out the water. You didn't pop him in the water. Y'all all walk out the water. He puts her down. How does that conversation end?
It wouldn't have got there. It wouldn't have got there. I can't tell you how what I would have said because it wouldn't have got there.
You popping him in the water?
Yeah, for sure.
First off, I'm not falling in the water.
Yeah, but we passed that. We passed that.
Locke washed away.
Bro.
You're not popping shit.
That shit in the water floating now. It's
gone. Yeah, works. So, Asa. Huh. How you been with any... African American female lately, bro.
Why did he do this?
Talking about black women?
Wait, he's trolling. He's trolling. Yeah. The line is trolling.
I mean, y'all know I don't.
No,
really
I'm saying no. I'm not saying.
Oh shit. No. Ayo, so LeBron James. LeBron James. Came out with a new shoe. Give me a little intermission, my nigga.
Hey, yo, real talk. This is a great listen. That video that we watch is a great listen for all men. That when women see you fall, 90% of the time, they are not going to wait for you to get back up. I promise you, they will only think about their own benefit because that's how they're taught.
Is that
so? I think this is a good lesson for all men. I promise you. You will find another one of her tomorrow because there's 2 million more women than men. So understand, Kings, you are the prize.
Talk your shit.
These women are everywhere in the world. I promise you, you'll find another one of her in a second. You feel me? Get your value up.
What was the percentage again?
There's 22 million more women than men.
The percentage you said of women that's going to let you fall.
90%. 90% of the percent is higher, honestly. But I really want to give a woman props because I've met a few.
You give a woman props.
How many women, I've met a few. How many women have let you fall?
Who hurt you?
We know. We already went over this. We know.
Look at that.
We know.
Look at that. He tried to shame me, y'all. Y'all hear that? This is classic. Okay, okay. How much time y'all got?
We got time.
You want to know the story?
No, we don't.
I want to hear the story.
We can save it for our Patreon, bro.
What is wrong with you?
Save it for the Patreon. Okay, let's put it like this. Again, guys.
I didn't start.
Guys, do we? Can we?
Did I gaslight you?
Not really.
Oh, okay, because you said this is classic. I was like,
I mean, but this is classic. I mean, I get this question a lot. So when I give out advice and I tell you that women only think about themselves first and then they'll think about you, that's not false. You know, and you and I both know
that. I agree to some degree. You're not wrong.
I mean, what do you mean to some degree? That it seems to be a little something there.
It's not 100%. I agree to some degree.
I mean, how much? Is it like 80, 70, 60,
50? I can't quantify it.
Okay, if you were looking at the numbers, right? Oh, let me pose this question.
Your numbers. You're going off your own perception. Perception is reality.
So no. What,
majority of the women in your life have hurt you, then you're going to believe that. If majority of the women in my life have not hurt me, I'm going to believe that all women are like that. If perception is reality.
That's correct.
Talk now, this shit, Monty.
Let me ask you a very specific question. When you go online and you look at the divorce rates. When you look at the divorce rate, when the percentage of divorces that are filed by women is 80%.
Half the time niggas be beating their ass, bro. It's not just women ain't shit. Bro, you have to
is that true?
Yeah, but you talking to that man about what he do now. Now you talking to him about what he do.
So you asked me.
But you gotta understand, men have such a bad play in a lot of things that happen too, bro. You can't just shame women about everything because
am I shaming women or telling the truth?
All two things can be.
I mean, I respect your emotions. Okay, let's get that clear.
Oh shit!
Emotional, yo. I'm emotional.
I respect it, but
you trying, niggas.
When you say I agree to a certain degree, you do realize that women live a very different life than us. They are always given something. They're always coddled. They're always protected. And they're always taught to look out for themselves. So where did I go wrong in that statement? Where am I wrong?
The fifth.
You never said you went wrong.
All right, let's move on.
The fifth.
Let's move on because I don't think Lamont's going to answer this question. What else we got?
All right, so Asa,
what's up?
With all your endeavors, we still have yet to see proof of your method working. So, are we in the process? Are we in the process of that?
Brothers,
what's his method?
My method.
Can I summarize it?
Yes, don't say nothing, bro. Just let him summarize it and keep going.
Sex, sandwich, and silence. That's
it. I heard about this.
That is his method.
Oh, sex, shit. Sandwich, silence. The three S's.
The three S's.
Put it on the shirt.
You don't need to talk about it. Nothing else about it. That's self-explanatory.
I'm getting a shirt.
Three wives. Sex, sandwich, silence, three wives.
Three to four.
So, how's the journey on that, brother?
It's great. I'm building my value. I'm getting my money up.
But do you have more than one yet?
He don't got one.
No. I don't think you understood what I just said.
Let me
go back.
Go ahead and read it.
Fuck your shit. Ayo, run it back.
You know what? I'm about to give Ace a credit. I think I kind of felt something where he was going.
Yeah.
I saw a nice meme. He said, I'm building my value.
Yes. Okay.
He said, you haven't let me get to where I'm going. I like that. I saw a nice meme that said that the black man is not truly loved until he can provide, bring him to the table. Is that true, Ace?
I don't think that's true.
Is that why you're building your value?
I think that you can do two things. You can either love women or understand them. I choose to understand them. No, you cannot. Because love is blind.
No, it is true. Love is blind, but it's not the only truth to it. If you understand what I'm saying.
You can love and understand women.
Love is blind.
The fuck?
Love is bliss. Wait. Love is a lot of things.
Would you okay?
You
okay.
Can know your woman and love your woman at the same time. That's stupid.
And you can understand how females work and still love them.
Yes, like I do. But I choose not to love women, and I choose to understand them. I believe they provide value. Yes.
What kind of value?
I mean, they're caring.
Some of them are feminine. They can take care of kids. They can run a household. They can cook. I mean, all the things that I am not great at, that they are. I mean, there's roles in a relationship. In the confines of a relationship, there are roles. There are things that women can do better than men, and there are things that men can do better than women. Okay. Make money, provide for a household. Pressure is made for shoulders, not hips.
I know someone that can make some money. You can't say it.
Here we go. All right, so now I don't agree with it, but you know I agree with a bar. So that's a bar. I got to celebrate the bar, but I do not agree with that. Women can handle weight, though.
Sure, but not on the same level as men consistently. Man. Because guess what? After a certain age, they're gonna want to settle down and get married and have kids.
Shout out to my valedictorian in law school, Marissa Bad Teeth. Come on, Marissa. This woman got them hardest section in school. She led everybody. Number one in our class since we started, since we stepped on campus. She got pregnant, stayed number one. I'm talking about, she's a real estate agent and she's an attorney. She's breadwinning. Like, you can't tell me there ain't nothing that women can't handle that we can handle. Right?
Don't say nothing yet, Asa. All he's going to say is, that's the 1%.
The exception doesn't make the rule. The exception doesn't make the
rule. Everyone you name, I know you could think of 5, 6, 7 strong women off the top of your head right now. If I give you time, at least 20, 30. But all he's going to tell you is, they're the exception. So before we go down that road, because you know how it goes. Jovan, you ain't got nothing to say about that, bro. You've been mad, dumb, quiet and shit.
Am I allowed to do this?
Yeah, do your thing, bro. It's Elliot's show.
Hey, hey, you getting some liquor? Yeah. Hey, can you give me a cup?
Bro, why you think everybody's a bartender? I'm playing, I got you.
Appreciate it, big dog. But yeah, so back to you guys' point. The exception doesn't make the rule, and I'm not taking anything away from them. But how many men can you say that are great mothers?
None. Huh? How many men can I say are great mothers? I can't tell you not one man that's a great mother.
That is a great answer.
Bruce Caitlyn Jenner.
That's a great... Shout out to Caitlyn Jenner.
We're not shouting. Shout out Caitlyn Jenner. Not shout out. Bro, chill out, bro. You got to shout out the alphabet people.
You feel me?
What?
What's up? Oh, whiskey.
So. Hello, Javon.
where were we at?
I have not seen my friend yet. This is crazy.
Lamont, you know we shooting right now, right? Why are you right here?
It's a special episode.
We missing the fight. You said it ain't started yet.
Oh my god, he's a real one.
So we're definitely gonna cut this scene out. So since we're cutting this scene out, Gang in this bitch, y'all know what it is. ATS in this motherfucker. Y'all already know what it's going down. You feel me? Look. And I promise you, since we probably gonna pull this up in a blooper or something, but I promise you, we about to be the number one company in the world. Look. Look.
Does Lamont have a mic on his shirt?
No.
Yes.
Oh, that's what I can hear.
No,
he's
never
going to not be heard.
I hear everything.
I think I heard
it. My mic wasn't working over here. Oops.
Is it working?
Shit. I guess you just couldn't hear me.
Have y'all seen the beef between the Jamaicans and Shikari?
Yeah, that's sad.
It's not sad, bro. It's just friendly competition. It's something, nigga. It's something we do.
Hold on, what is it?
What's going on?
Oh, they just been taking jabs. A resort owner in Jamaica came out and said, if you need some time to slow down, I give you a free trip, blah, blah, blah. Just shooting jabs. Then Shikari liked some bullshit on Twitter. Just little childish shit. I like it because it builds competition. Because they have to see each other again. And I hope the best for Shikari. But I told y'all what was going to happen. I told y'all where I'm from.
She didn't run her best time, bro. That's not even like
what that got to do with me.
I mean, I feel that. I'm just saying she's going to be back and they're going to get burnt.
Burnt is crazy. She broke a record.
I don't know about burnt, bro.
She broke a record. Shikari and Jovan, we already had this conversation, but you were wrong. And I told y'all Shikari would be in third place at best. And where was she?
In last. So, like she deserves.
Why did she deserve that?
Because she fucked up the first time.
Don't take the bait. You can't.
She fucked up the first time. She couldn't even. She couldn't even put the weed down.
Her mom just died. It was her mom.
So? Right? And? Oh, you think that's an excuse? She didn't even know her parents. Stop playing with me with that bullshit excuse.
Bro, I don't know my dad, and I was still shook when he got shot.
Okay, I understand that.
How is that you don't have
it. Okay, okay. So,
he wasn't ready for a real life.
For a real life moment. Wait a second. The expectation for you, if you had a job at that moment, if you had a job to do, and you got shit-faced drunk, they're going to expect you to come into work, correct?
She still went to work.
Wait a second.
She was just high.
Wait a second. if work says you can't smoke weed and you smoke weed, what's going to happen to you if every drug takes you the next day?
It depends on the job and the protocol.
No, don't try to find a little loophole. I understand what this is what you do. But look, listen. If you go to work after smoking weed and they drug test you and you have weed in your system,
you
what's going to
fired.
Happen?
You get fired. I understand.
No, I'm not going to let you do that because it depends on your situation, my nigga. It don't just go black and white.
Wait a second. It is definitely black and white because I promise you, if that was a man,
Let me speak.
Go ahead, my bad.
I've worked for plenty of organizations where it'd be Walmart, Target, Pepsi. I've worked for different Chinese stores. If I have a loss in the family and they know me on that, I'm a worker. So when I work, I work. They'll give me that leeway because they know what just happened. All I have to do is tell them what happened. You don't automatically get fired.
Also, why was she the only sprinter that got tested?
Was she?
She was.
I didn't know that.
I've never even thought.
Knew that.
I need to see
that
article.
That's also not fair. But I mean.
Life isn't fair.
Here we go.
Oh my god!
Next excuse. See, we love to make up excuses. We love to make up excuses for their fuck ups. But when we fuck up, that's
your excuse. She can beat you in 100-meter dash on her worst day.
So
and that's a woman.
And
how does it make you feel?
That's her profession. She should. It make me feel no type of way. And. What does that have to do with the real world?
Jason wants to be the dominant person at all points of time.
Yes, I will be.
How does it make you feel that you can't dominate her?
I don't give a fuck. She's not attractive.
She was attractive.
You're not to do anything.
Because you're talking out of the confines that you're talking to the confines like I like her.
I know her on a personal level. You can't beat her one thing. You got to beat her another. So you got to be more attractive than her?
No. You're not more attractive.
Look, first of all, first of all, she
don't like niggas.
She looks like Rajon Rondo. Let's be honest. Bro,
she looks like she could be Rondo's daughter. I give
you feel that. Me? She has manly features. That's not attractive. Though. But you're talking to the confines. Confines that I'm going to be around her for any type of period of time.
No, because you're switching the subject. He said, how does it make you feel? Yes, it did. He said, how does it make you feel? Bro, let me talk.
Explain what you're talking
about. Let me talk, nigga.
Okay, I'm listening.
God damn.
Go ahead.
He said, how does it make you feel that you cannot beat her in a race? Not that he looks better than her. Not that you look worse than her.
You changed it. I mean,
you changed it.
One-on-one. He asked you a single question. You were an athlete at one point in your life.
Single question. How does it make you feel that you cannot beat her?
If she's more athletic than you.
It don't make me feel no type of way.
Boom. That's how you have to say it. End it.
I don't feel with those type of things. Now, I just think.
Don't speak on her ability if you can't beat it yourself.
Okay. How about this? How about this?
What's up?
How do you feel that she can make more money than you right now?
Ooh.
It don't matter because it's going to come back to me tenfold. Y'all don't understand. Look. Understand something.
Y'all got understand.
Men don't necessarily hit their financial.
Listen. When you listen to Asa, bro, you have to. Rip the skin off the potato, my nigga. Like, you got... There's a message in there. I shit you not, bro. I swear to God, I sound crazy. There be a message in there. He don't know how to say it right.
Okay.
It's in there.
So say it for him.
It's in there. So talk your shit.
Rip the skin off the potato?
Talk your shit, because he was about to talk your shit.
So men don't necessarily hit their financial prime until age 45 to 55. So right now, what I'm doing right now, I'm building for the future. All the work that I'm putting in right now for the business that I am in, I'm probably not going to see no proceeds until 45 to 55. Yes, every single year I'm going to increase little by little, but it's about the growth. It's not about where I am right now. Now, before, back in the day when I was young, I was trying to get it because I was looking at all these rappers. I was listening to all this freaking music. Let's get this money, blah, blah, blah. And I'm trying anything to get some money. But guess what? That fast money ran out quick.
What's the crazy
not
thing
if you do it right.
That fast money ran out quick. So she can make more money than me right now.
Look.
So she can make more money than me right now. Hold on. Wait a second. Let me finish my statement real quick. So she can make more money than me right now. But I promise you, when she's single at 40 and 50 years old and she's struggling to find a man that's going
to
want
to
be with her, that money ain't going to be nothing. Because I promise you,
So you don't think she's going to build her money from now until
but whenever you're going to be? But why was it about the money? She might. Now it's about her. She might. About herself.
She might, but it don't matter if she make more money than me. To ask you guys this question.
Bro, I don't care, bro. Hey, yo. Shout out Shikari. And let's keep doing your thing.
Stop smoking that damn weed.
Jamaica, we are win.
Come on now.
Smoke weed every
day. I smoke weed, so do what you want to do to cope. But as long as you can handle your vices, that's all it is.
Smoke weed every day.
So, what's the craziest thing you did for money?
What's wrong with money?
I plead the fifth on this one.
You was selling dick. You was selling dick.
What's the question? What's the craziest thing he did for money?
Craziest thing he did for money? Because he said, what alluded to that?
For money?
Yeah.
I plead the fifth.
Yeah. All right, so do you have like a plan B or plan C story you could tell us instead?
Hold on, you're not going to tell us a story?
No, bro.
I can't reveal too much. I can't reveal too much information because my partner had passed away.
Okay.
Over some money and the case is still.
All right, man, pending. But RIP, buddy.
I was just telling a different story. Give me
I'm saying, like, give me a story we could actually talk about, my nigga. You didn't have to take us that dark path.
I mean, it's not really that dark. Death happens every day. You know what I'm saying? It's really not that big of a deal.
However you feel, it was dark. So let's keep moving.
I mean, let's keep moving. So one of the things I also wanted to talk about is this.
So you gonna change the subject?
Yes.
Change the subject out.
Hey, can we do a Madden tournament after this?
This nigga Lamont.
Since he changed the subjects.
What you mean?
Since he changed the fucking subject.
How am I changing the subjects? I thought we was really. I thought you guys said continue. So I was continuing.
No. Wait. Continue. Answer the question.
Okay. Oh, so what was the question?
He do this every time.
Yeah. And he don't get me because I remember my question.
I know the question.
Go ahead.
What is the craziest thing you do ever done for money?
Oh, that's right, that's right. I was a bartender.
All right, let's go. Let's continue.
Bro, why do we put up with this nigga, bro? Oh.
Y'all put up with him.
Shout out to the birthday boy, man.
Shout out to Ramon. Special shout out to
hey. You want to get in the camera one time, though?
Hey, look, he look camera shy.
Everything on his head.
He look camera shy, you know. But he's my other mentor. You know what I'm saying? So
what have you learned from him? Because it's like a contrast when I look at y'all. So what have you learned from him?
Basically, he's the way he carries himself on a professional level, the way he handles his business, the way he just goes about. Improving every single day, and every single time you talk to him, he's working on something.
Yes, sir.
And that's exactly how manhood should be. You should never have a downtime unless you're spending time with your family.
He is a legend.
Other than that,
factual thing Ace said,
he is putting in the work every single day, 16 to 18 hours
a
day.
Right now, that's why you're not in here, but it's,
you know what I'm saying? So even on his birthday, he's working right now. He's not taking no days off because he understands the importance of what we're building.
18 hours
right
a day.
Here. You feel me? Yeah. Ramon is not playing with y'all, bro. Y'all think this is a game? This ain't no fucking game, y'all. Stop playing with me. Get this mic out of my motherfucking face, because I promise you, this nigga's about to be on another level. Nigga, when you look at this man in his eyes.
Eddie, your left foot.
Look, when I look at this man in his eyes, and them eyes is glistening.
You sound like you playing with him, bro.
Turn his mic down.
And I'm looking at his soul. I can see. He's going to be successful. Now, his soul was already took.
His soul was took.
Who took it, bro?
I don't know where Ace is going.
Who took that shit, bro? We got to go find it.
Yeah, hello?
Oh, here we go. Now, his soul is still intact. You know, I haven't, you know, his soul is still there. But his professionalism and the way he carries himself as a man. Even though we have different beliefs.
So you just take what you want out of your mentors.
Yes.
That's good. I think that's obviously, how it should be, though.
Yes.
I think that's how it should
be. So I have multiple mentors on different levels. So where I want to be, I have a mentor.
Okay. I don't think, responding to Lamont, I don't think you should take everything from your mentor, but I think you should take everything positive.
Right. You also learn from their wrongs.
There's a lot of stuff that's positive in Ramon that Asa has not taken. Can we admit that?
Wait. Like what?
Oh, please don't.
I would say the way he honors women.
That's exactly what I was gonna say.
What? And he has a African American
queen.
Queen.
He's been trying.
And he got a bun baking as we speak.
Look,
He got a little chocolate baby in the oven as we speak.
Shout out to the chocolate babies.
Shout out chocolate baby.
Y'all know what it is. And I applaud you guys for taking that step on into marriage and fatherhood and everything like that. But for me personally, I just don't find them attractive.
Okay.
Well, that's just me. That's me personally. The average black woman weighs 185 pounds.
Wait, 100 what?
Who was that? Where'd you get it from?
Oh my
god. 185
pounds. He was doing so good. And he just threw that shit in there.
Where'd you get it from?
What? What is the average weight of a black woman?
No, he's just shut up. His number.
Aaliyah. Joe Vaughn.
Look it up.
Why you do that?
Aaliyah. I mean, Jovan. I'm trying to keep it respectful because we're in.
Okay, what's your problem with a black woman that weighs 185 pounds? Is it because she weighs more than you? Is that insecurity with you?
Wait a second.
Because why? She's my better whoop you.
Why is she? Okay, first of all,
she's just not disrespecting.
Chill, what he's bad. Y'all niggas wild. Chill, what he's bad.
So the average African American woman.
Why are you keep saying African American?
Okay, the average black woman.
Yes. Not every. There's two different.
Classes. Okay.
African American.
Okay, I got you.
You're African American.
Hey,
if you're American, you're black.
If you're from Africa, you're not from Africa. You're not African.
And you live here.
You're not African American. You're African descent.
What?
Anyway, continue.
I'm so confused.
The average black female weighs 180 pounds.
Where'd you get that from?
Yes.
Where'd you get that stat from?
I can pull up my statistics after this.
Why are you doing that after?
I can pull up my statistics after this because I feel like the conversation. Yes, I feel like the conversation is more important.
The average black woman in America or just
in America?
They got two in this room and they both not.
So what's the average weight for a woman who's 5'4"? On the BMI chart.
So my thing is, where you going with this? Because you like Hispanic women, right?
Just asking a question.
I just want to know where he's going with this. Okay, the average weight for a black woman is 187 pounds.
185.
Oh, okay. Well,
Just stop. Let's keep on going.
Average weight for a Hispanic woman is 186 right here.
It's crazy.
So that's what you fuck with.
So where are you going with this? I'm confused. Like,
so you're discriminating
based off of color now, not weight, because
Wait a second. Because I've dated black women before.
One?
No, you multiple.
Who hurt him?
Here we go with the same. Come on now. If you really want to know the answer, I'm asking you again. How much time do we have?
That's not shame, bro.
Wow.
If you would like us to stop bringing that up, say that.
Yeah. No. I enjoy it. But if you want to hear the story,
it's my side.
We've all dated a black woman.
I'm gonna just keep it a stack. Half the men in our group message have women that are other than black for a good reason.
Not for a good reason.
What's the rest of your wife?
I don't have a wife.
I mean, your woman?
She's Hispanic.
Okay. Why did you choose her?
It just happened to be that night. I got it.
Hey, you left foot.
Numero uno.
That's why.
So I dated black women before. Oh shoot.
Mm-hmm.
I'll say the race.
It's crazy. It came back to you.
Y'all came to New Orleans because when I was out here, I only had Hispanic women and white women as occupants because there wasn't that many black women out here. I'm in Louisiana. I'm loving it, bro. It's like talking city.
You gotta know where you're coming from, bro. Like it's San Antonio. We're in Little Mexico. This is Little Mexico. Like I told you before, if I was in Houston,
yeah, or
honest, I would have had a black female.
Javon. I understand.
Yeah. Say
I would have.
I understand, but yeah. You chose.
I want the fucking Kingsville.
You chose a Latina.
Wait a second.
Before we continue, let's acknowledge that you chose a Latina for a reason, correct?
It's not because of her
skin. It's not because she was Latina.
It was by chance, bro. He met at a party at my house.
I don't believe in by chance.
That's what's up. We don't care.
And it's multiple. It happens.
You said destiny then, my G. That's what it's supposed to be.
Destiny.
There's no such thing as destiny either.
I got a sister named Destiny.
If I would have left the shit to chance, I would have picked the name by chance. Shout out to Destiny.
Wait. Look,
Look, guys.
Giovanni.
What are y'all thoughts on manifesting?
What's up?
Hold on, let's just close up this subject really quick before we move on.
My whole point in you saying that, well, my opposition in it is Jovan did not walk outside and say, I want a Hispanic woman.
For this reason. He had a good vibe at my house with this girl. They end up having good chemistry.
And it happened.
Worked out for every other reason I didn't fell into place.
I'm with a black woman and I love my woman. I did not walk outside and say, I want a black woman. I just vibed with her.
And I feel like if you think that way, you're limiting yourself. Because you never know which you can find. Love is love, bro. Like,
talk to everybody, bro.
That's what's up that you guys
do. You might overlook speaking to a black woman thinking that, you know, just because you have whatever bias that you have, that could be your soulmate. Your twin flame.
That's what's up.
You might have a crazy dynamic with that person.
So
that leads to my question. Can I ask a question, guys?
Go ahead, Lamont.
If money and sex didn't exist, what would you look for in a relationship?
Loyalty.
That's a given. What next?
Well, you tell me. I'm going around.
So if that's a given,
let's start with Eddie. Let's start with Eddie, and then
we started with you.
Then he diverts. You said that
we started with Eddie because I want to kind of keep this, you know, organized a little bit. So
how's organized? Pretty organized, bro. We started with you
first, and then you.
Oh, okay. You said loyalty.
Yeah. So,
but that's a given.
Okay, so that's mine. So what's yours? Thank you.
Well, y'all already know my top three.
No, sex. I said if sex and money didn't exist.
If sex and money did not exist, Asa.
What would you gain and look for in a relationship if sex and money didn't exist?
Number one, she has to be friendly. She has to be feminine. She has to be submissive. She has to be able to cook. She has to be able to clean. She has to be able to produce kids. She has to be able to know her place in the relationship. She has to know
how
to
be.
Now what do you bring to the table?
This nigga asked for one thing.
Wait a second. That's two questions in one. We gotta let everybody else answer first.
Everybody only answered one thing, bro. You can't do this now.
So I mean,
I can't even expect all these things from a person. Like, so I want
to wait a second. What is the most important thing you look for, Asa? The most important.
Can I answer?
There we go.
I say loyalty and compatibility.
Okay,
that's a great one.
Thank you. Feminine, beautiful, and inspirational.
Okay, I like that.
I told you you'd be saying some shit that makes sense.
And once in a while.
You have to bring them back in.
It's like you got to dig through the doo-doo, and then it's going to be like a little
diamond ring in a diamond.
Yeah, it's going to be a crazy-ass diamond ring in it.
I just don't need that doo-doo.
Yeah, I'm not fucking with the doo-doo, so I'm going to leave that bitch right there.
Bro, what is wrong with you, Asa? Can we talk about this?
Wait a second. you gave my ass already.
Listen,
that long ass list you had.
Yeah. You said so
what's the top three that you?
What's wrong with them?
You know, honesty, loyalty.
Why is it?
Loyalty is a given, though.
Loyalty is not given because
is a given. If you're gonna be with her, you're gonna expect her not to sleep with any other guys.
He's
correct?
Not wrong. Loyalty should be a given.
Loyalty is a given. So stop being generic. We have to actually be innovative. We have to actually be able to think about these things when you're looking for a woman.
So answer the
loyalty.
Question.
I already asked the question. Feminine, beautiful, and inspirational. Period.
Feminine, beautiful, and inspirational.
Feminine on a big part of feminine.
Loyalty is a given. But
loyalty is a given.
But feminine isn't a given?
No, because there's a lot of women out here that don't know how to be women. They don't know how to cook. They know how to clean.
There's a lot of women out here not being loyal, nigga. What the fuck?
So they don't know how to be loyal.
If a woman how's that not given?
What does it entail for a man to be a man then, since women don't know how to be women, allegedly? What does it take for a man to be a man?
I mean, there's an onus on the man, too, because you got to understand, there's a lot of men nowadays that don't know how to be men because there's a lack of male leadership. There's a lack of male role models.
Tell us. So how do you be
a man? What's your example on being a man?
You have to be able to provide.
Okay.
You have to be able to protect.
Okay.
You have to be able to know how to. You need to be able to know everything, because if a woman has a question, you need to be able to answer it. You need to be able to live enough life. You need to be able to live enough life to where whatever question she has, you will be able to answer.
There's diamonds in the doodle, my nigga. You just gotta dig through it. Come on, bro.
I don't see no diamonds on this one.
Talk your shit, Asa. He talking right now.
That nigga said he said motherfucking stainless steel.
What else does it make you know? Because these are all things that you said also that will be on your Patreon.
You need to have good character. Strong character, which means whatever you believe in, whoever you believe in, whatever God you believe in, you need to believe in him with all your heart and all your might. Period. Point blank. There is no exceptions about that. You need to be able to teach. You are going to be a teacher, because you're going to be able to teach your kids and bring them up to be in your image and to be in your likeness. Yes, they're going to take your character away from the mother for like the first 5 years, but then after that, you have to be able to set the tone. You have to be a hard worker. You have to know how to work. You have to know about money. You have to know how money moves. You know, you have to know how to create. If you don't know how to create, then you are nothing. I say that again. I say that again. If you don't know how to create, you are nothing as a man. Period. Every single man in here knows how to create something. This is why I'm in this group. Which is why I'm in this group, because you challenge me every single day. Now the question that you might ask me might be asinine. I understand that. But you guys do bring up good points, and I appreciate the challenge, because I think it does not need to be an echo room in here. So let's go back. Let's go forward again, right? So after you have to have good character. After you have to have a belief, strong belief system, you have to be able to have a strong family. You have to have a strong support system. Do you have a network of individuals that know what to do in a time of, if you get kicked out of your house right now, can you call somebody? If you need to get a deal done right now, can you call somebody?
Oh my niggas.
So the reason why I'm bringing this up, because if anything were to happen as far as in the future, a man needs to know what to do. That is a role of a man. You should not want anything else.
Sit here and think I'm the only one that agree with this nigga. I hate when y'all do this. He's not wrong. What did he say was wrong?
Yo, chill, bro.
The nigga be talking his shit. Just gotta dig in the doodoo.
I just told you I don't like digging in doodoo, so I'm gonna let this say it, nigga. I ain't gonna tell him that he's right, but I ain't saying I'm wrong. He ain't wrong.
There's a message in all his bullshit where he's not wrong. All of it. Where he's not wrong.
He's like the antagonist sometimes. He wants to be different.
So he forces the different shit. Yes.
Right. So there's not always games, because sometimes you're just going off the cuff.
But something can be right in it.
So Lamont, the biggest thing that you're talking about is getting triggered with your emotions, and I get that. So one of the things I always do is I try to actually put my emotions aside, and I act like I'm in a business meeting.
Hey, yo,
no matter what is being said, I take that with a grain of salt, and I'm looking at
the time. He's just mad because my man's talking this shit.
Let's not get this confused. I do respect your emotions and your feelings. I do. You know what I'm saying? So I'm not trying to disregard that at all. So let me just get that clear.
Alright. Go ahead, bro.
Two. Is that a question? Was that just a statement?
Y'all heard that, man.
That was a statement.
Oh. Hey, E-Money, you heard that, man?
That was a statement.
He heard that, man.
Yeah, that was a statement.
Eddie, you good on what my man's is saying to you? Yeah. Alright, so don't question him no more.
Yeah, you got it.
That's Ace of the Chief. Ace of the Titan.
Nah. So every man who's here in a relationship is a Titan.
Yeah.
Every man who's in a marriage or relationship is a Titan. Let's just put that out there. I'm not the only one.
Nobody said you was all. Yo, let me do my thing.
My bad.
It's not really like a you thing. we got. We'll switch to the segue. Football season coming up.
We need to get the fantasy football thing on.
Yeah, Eric, what's up with the fantasy?
That's what you touch.
Why the fuck you lying?
Why you always? Everybody already claimed their teams, of course. Asa, you don't watch sports.
No.
Will you be attending this season?
Put that on the record right now. I'm winning this season, by the way. FYI.
Who's winning?
Put it on the
record. Hey, what happens when
I'm not talking to
Lamont. Hold on, who's winning? What happens when I beat you?
Who's winning?
That just
might
happen.
You talking about fantasy?
Let's put a little bet on it. Let's put a little money on it. Let's say $100.
Ace, you're terrible at fantasy.
Let's pay $100.
$100 that Ace will not beat.
$100 that I won't beat Lamont.
I'm putting on the record right now that I'm winning this season, period.
You're winning.
Not betting any money on that, but betting him personally, he would not beat me.
Oh, and look, for the record, I don't watch sports.
I want my money.
For the record, I don't watch sports, but I will play just to beat Lamont.
You're not that guy, pal. Trust me. You're not that guy.
I'm not that guy, but in this, I will be.
All right. So, you feel me? Who your team? Ayo?
Ayo,
who's your team? Your team is who?
Oh, we talking about,
I'm going to buy everybody pizza.
I'm big college boys.
Okay.
I watch, Texas football, Hook'em Horns, bitch ass.
Like,
done
that?
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. All right.
who your NFL team?
LSU, huh? LSU now, son? Yeah.
Fuck the LSU. Yeah. Nigga, we ain't get to y'all now. Hey, hold on. Chill out. We ain't get to y'all yet. We talking to him. So, your team, what?
Texas, bro.
Okay, who's your NFL team?
The Colts.
What you project y'all going this year?
We win in the bowl.
Why are
we
talking about next?
Okay,
next.
But what you ask me?
Let's be real about it, though.
Okay, let me be real about it.
Yes. You're a realist, bro. What
Carson Wentz?
Hell do y'all
have? Hold on.
Carson Wentz gets hurt week 5.
Okay,
hear me out.
Okay,
Sam Ehlinger steps in
and wins y'all the bowl
and takes us to the AFC Championship.
So AFC Championship.
You just said the bowl, though.
No, he be real. He be real now.
Carson Wentz gonna get hurt. He gonna fuck it up for everybody.
Cool. You team. College.
Ball so hard, university, my nigga. You know what's popping up here.
Yeah.
He said, "Ball so hard, university."
I
want to
come there.
What state that is?
That's the Ravens. Oh. That's what Terrell Suggs used to say on his little shit.
Yeah, I don't know about the Ravens.
Ball so hard, university.
Fuck them niggas.
Terrell Suggs.
Don't they get lies?
Fuck them niggas.
Saying be more up in this hole.
Okay.
So.
Riding in
them city. Hey,
can y'all stop?
Hey, Malcolm Kelly.
Let's go.
Malcolm Kelly.
Hey, side note.
Hey, real quick, we going Super Bowl again. Hey. This motherfucker, what?
Go ahead. You talk.
This motherfucker better not choke again.
He's going to blow up.
Lamar, come on, bro.
He's choking. And we're going to talk about this because I gave up on Lamar. That was his last season last year for me.
I drafted him.
I think he's terrible. He's a great athlete. He's a bad quarterback, bro. He's a bad quarterback.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, I think you're
going to talk about it. Like I said, that is my opinion. I'm not here to argue with you. You a Ravens fan. You're going to feel how you feel. Last year was my last year giving faith into that man until he do something.
I'm about to go Ace on your ass. Keep talking.
All right, so what do you
want? Ace can't name me 10 NFL teams.
Holiday. What do y'all got projected?
Yes,
projected.
I can.
What do you got them projected to go?
Division championship.
Division championship?
Yeah, I'll say that.
Okay. Ace, so we going to skip you just because you don't have an NFL team. Are you claiming anybody this year?
Pick a team.
Miami Dolphins.
Okay.
Y'all know I like the bitches in Miami. You feel me?
Hey, I'm not real.
They got all the big booty Latinas over there. You feel me? Shout out to the BBL gang. You feel me? Finna come down and knock a couple of y'all out. You know.
Okay,
Don't put a cap on.
Don't put a cap on.
Next.
You're not that guy, pal.
You're not. Okay, next. All right. What do y'all got? What do you got them projected going?
These nuts.
Got him.
What do you got them projected?
Yo, can we talk about the lack of focus there is in this podcast? <Okay. laughs>
What do you have them projected going?
10-6.
You need one more game, bro.
11-6.
11-6. Okay. Good job. Okay, me. No one skip me. Go D. I'm last.
Well, we have two Saints fans in the building, so I feel like he's going to piggyback off of what I say.
Okay, so this is Lamont and Eddie at the same time.
What I'm going to say is Jameis Winston is y'all quarterback. We're just going to say.
So,
what I'm going to say is
Hold on, hold on, hold on. Go ahead.
All right, seeing as how we beat the Super Bowl champions twice in the regular season last year, I definitely think we're going to the NFC divisional game. It's going to be between us and the Bucks, obviously. I think the winner of that game is going to the bowl, realistically.
Okay. College?
Oh, LSU.
Kingsville, come on. Ew. Going over.
Okay, we're not talking about that.
Going
Eddie,
over.
Go ahead. Add on to that. Piggyback.
I'm just going to agree with everything Lamont said. Okay. Everything Lamont just said was factual.
Well, Jameis Winston is not taking y'all to no type of playoffs.
What's your record? What is your record?
I'm going to say 11-6.
11-6 is very realistic for us.
11-6.
That's something we might, you know, have.
I definitely see y'all going 9-8, bro.
How much money did
DeMarcus
Robinson
win?
We ain't losing
to,
though, Javon. Like, we're not.
Can I see y'all schedule real quick?
Yeah.
Did Drew Brees retire?
Yeah.
Yes, Drew Brees.
Oh, thank God. He was looking older than a motherfucker.
That nigga was throwing. He threw the fuck out that bitch.
Nah, he was looking older than a motherfucker.
We just looked at the record, nigga.
He threw for 80,000 yards.
I'm talking about.
I have to live through it.
Watching him.
He wasn't going 5 yards down the field.
Yeah, bro. Like, watching him, he looked old in the moment.
He looked rough.
It was a little slower to get up. Like, Drew Brees was looking beat the fuck up.
Yes, man.
All right, same schedule 2021. Let me see here.
Look, hold on real quick. Hey, why y'all doing that? Let me bring up another subject.
But I'm still here. I'm still here.
Brittany Renner came out with a video talking about PJ.
Okay.
My bad. Next.
Damn.
This nigga, Brittany Renner is tripping.
When I hit this nigga, I'm bad. Your niggas tell me stop hitting him.
This is what I'm saying. He said my nigga.
But like, listen, keep on doing that. They ain't gonna listen to nothing.
Listen, bro.
I'm telling him, I'm talking. He's like, Brittany Renner. Fuck Brittany Renner.
I'm not even in the same zone as y'all right now. Because I be hot. Y'all okay. Just be drunk.
I say I got it. I say, Asa, I got it.
We got to get a little aggressive when he drink a little bit. You feel me? That's all it is. Nigga. So what you mad at?
Bro, right, what's up?
Hold on.
What's up, bro?
Hold on. Wait a second.
We got to talk here.
I think there's some anger that needs to be.
Ain't no anger, nigga.
We have the schedule up. Can we go back to this real quick?
Yeah, for sure.
So realistically,
all right. So we got the Packers.
Y'all winning that bitch because I'm gonna be there. We winning that motherfucker.
Hold on, we going down the same schedule.
Yes,
we might lose over the game, Packers.
Hold on,
whoa,
stop. Let me. This is on me, bro.
Chill, bro.
Nigga, the Packers, y'all are losing.
Opening
0-1.
We're gonna win that one. Okay.
0-1. Y'all play. Shut up.
That's realistic.
Shut up.
We gotta get our coaches.
The Panthers, y'all are winning.
They're losing to the Panthers.
No, they're winning.
I got them all.
Barely.
Keep going.
Okay, yeah. I'm 1-1. The Patriots.
We're winning them.
The Patriots. Patriots. Hey, yo. Patriots.
Patriots, they're winning that. I got them 1-2.
2-1. Giants, they're winning. 3-1. Washington.
That's gonna be a good ass game. We come together now, we might win that.
3-2.
It's possible.
I got them losing that one. 2-3.
I got 3-2.
Seahawks losing that one. 2-4. Buccaneers.
Wait.
We haven't lost to the Seahawks.
You said we're winning Washington, so Seahawks.
No, I did not. I said y'all losing that one.
We're losing Washington?
Yes.
Oh, that's disrespectful. I don't want to go through
that. Taylor Heineke finna do y'all niggas.
Washington?
Y'all losing.
Washington football
name. In Washington. In Washington.
Breathing exercise.
In Washington. Oh, y'all losing to the Seahawks.
You're still the same.
Linda.
It's crazy. Remember.
Y'all ain't got Michael Thomas.
Fuck that mean, nigga.
He's gonna be back by that game.
Yo, what's fuck your that. Passive aggressive?
He's back by that game.
Stop yelling at my.
What I got? 2-3. I got 2-3. I got 2-3. I'm talking about me, nigga. This is me.
Yo, can you let my man go through?
That's what I'm saying, bro.
Michael Thomas is back at this point.
Huh?
Michael Thomas is back at this point.
Okay. Michael Thomas is going to Pittsburgh anyway. So. Go. So Buccaneers, y'all losing 2-4.
We beat them up.
Shut up.
It's not the same quarterback.
You lost to them when it matters. I don't understand that.
Y'all 2-4.
We beat them 2 out of 3.
2-4.
Okay, continue.
The Falcons, y'all winning.
Win.
3-4. The win. Titans, y'all are losing.
Win.
The Titans, dick, y'all are man. Losing.
Why are we losing to them they niggas?
The Titans don't keep
do shit. Julio ain't do shit when he played for the
Falcons. Nigga, he has Derrick Henry, nigga. They have three fucking. Okay,
fuck that nigga.
It's me, bro. It's me. They have no what?
You ain't talk. Hold on. You ain't talk all podcasts.
That nigga be high.
Why is he so angry?
He's wearing off.
Because I don't like being disrespectful. Y'all motherfuckers disrespectful.
What am I? 3-5?
Smoke weed every day.
I'm in 3-4? No, that was 3-5. Titans 3-5.
We in 3-5 right now.
Eagles, y'all winning. 4-5. Bills, y'all losing. 4-6.
Y'all losing to the
Cowboys. Y'all are. I hope to God y'all win, bro.
We played a
5-6, bro. The Jets, y'all are winning. 6-6. Buccaneers, y'all
win the second game. We can't win twice.
Hush.
Don't we beat the second game? You have to
hush.
Let's see a little bit.
Hush. All right,
go ahead.
What the fuck is wrong?
Buccaneers, y'all losing. 6-7. Dolphins. I'm doing my mouth wrong because this is not.
I don't know.
He on week 20 and he only got 12. There's no way.
We got the Dolphins, the Panthers, and the Falcons.
All right, so make your picks. Then we'll go
through the Dubs. That's 11. That's 10 and 7.
I see the Panthers going 1-1 with y'all.
I was about to say, y'all schedule sounds like kind of easy.
But the Panthers going 1-1.
I'm flushing both of those, bro.
The Panthers going 1-1. The Dolphins going win on some fluke shit. On some fluke shit.
The Dolphins?
Bro, fuck their schedule. Y'all think Jameis is going to take y'all?
bro,
to the AFC Championship.
I don't think y'all making the playoffs.
Yes,
he learned that year in the brief.
All we have to do, all we have to do, is just the Bucks.
Everybody don't learn, bro.
He's a 5,000-yard quarterback, and he had 1 year to learn.
And last year, 30 interception throwing quarterback.
This nigga keep on saying it's just the Bucks.
We beat the Bucks beat us in the playoffs by 10. We beat the hell out of them in the regular season. So what are you talking about?
You ain't talking all podcast.
Stop talking on my Saints.
Yelling in the mic.
Stop talking about him.
11-6
Jameis
Winston is winning us a playoff game. And okay. I put that
on my
FSU, nigga. What's up, nigga? FSU, nigga. What's up?
How much y'all trying to put on that?
That Jameis Winston is going to win a playoff game?
No, no, no. Y'all going to get to the playoffs.
Another bet.
Oh, I got $100 right now.
I'll bet you a punch in the dick.
On the record.
Punch in the dick.
So you think we're not making the playoffs? I'm putting this in my phone right now.
Y'all not making the playoffs.
I got other kids.
You said we're not making the playoffs off of that.
That's
schedule?
So disrespectful.
We've won the
NFC 4 years in a row.
You gave us 9 games. 9 games is the playoffs at minimum.
I missed. I didn't give y'all 9 games. I was at 7, and I missed 4 of them.
Basically 9 games.
I get.
That's like saying the
Lamont.
Who do you play every year that y'all?
I missed like.
That's like saying the Texans are going to win y'all division.
Huh?
The Texans is going to win y'all's division?
They good.
It's between Oklahoma and Texas.
If Deshaun plays. No, he's talking about
Deshaun
the Texans.
Deshaun.
If Deshaun plays. No, the Titans are going to win our division. That's how.
The Titans definitely winning the division.
I'm about to put this on my phone. I'm about to put my money on
it. It's on camera, buddy.
What's the last? I know, but I got to remember when it comes.
What's your
how the fuck he stand behind the camera like Batman? I ain't even notice that nigga was
talking. I'm sorry.
What's the last week?
You Gucci?
It's going good.
You good?
I don't know what you're.
Breezy?
Okay.
Yeah, I'm good. January 9th. Yeah. Set my alarm. I don't know.
You gonna step back in at any point?
Can I do my team? Can I do my team?
Please.
When did he leave? I don't even know.
Y'all losing to the Browns anyway, nigga. Sorry.
He's the bet that Gotham needs.
Okay, anyway, my team is.
Y'all ain't getting past the Browns. I don't give a
shut
fuck.
Shut your ass up, nigga, because I'm getting on your team.
All that winning and shit just to lose to the Browns, get to beat the fuck up. I don't want to hear shit from you. Hurry up.
How many Super Bowls I got?
So angry.
How many Super Bowls I got?
How many Super Bowls you got?
Nigga, we got 6, nigga!
In your lifetime!
We got 6, nigga! We leading this bitch, country! We leading this bitch, nigga!
Sit down!
We leading this bitch, nigga!
In your lifetime!
I'm gonna fuck all that.
You always yelling.
He talking about me fucked up. What are you leading this bitch, nigga?
Nigga,
how many Super Bowls you saw your team win?
3.
You seen your team win 3?
3.
The Cardinals?
3.
What was the other one?
I'll look him up, bro.
Yeah. You over. You out.
Don't worry about it, brother.
You out of here.
Y'all,
since you've been a fan.
Yeah.
Because you picked up being a fan.
I picked up being a fan since I was a young boy. My mom's a Pittsburgh fan.
Tell
on God.
Tell
on God.
He knows.
On baby Jesus.
He know.
Tell tomorrow.
I was a young little nigga. I was watching the Pittsburgh game, bro. They said the Steelers. They said, I said, nigga, they got to be good. They steal the ball from the other team. That's how I become a Steelers fan.
It's always about the bars.
I was a little nigga, bro. That was a real nigga.
Oh, these niggas.
They gotta be good. They steal the ball from the other team. They gotta be good.
How are you still standing?
They got nigga. So you got 6, bitch ass nigga.
Yo!
Hey, stop playing.
You got to
know what it is. You know what I'm talking about? OTS shit, nigga. ATS shit. OTS, ATS, nigga. Got these fucked up, nigga. Nigga. Hey, Juju. Hey, rip that shit, blood.
Yeah, I know.
Not, but for real. You know what I'm talking about?
The Steelers ain't doing shit this year.
Thank you.
Hold on. Let me talk.
Yo, what the fuck?
I got us projected making the playoffs and losing first round. Honestly.
He did all of that just to say that?
At least we making the playoffs, bitch. Yeah, y'all not making the playoffs.
Just so y'all know, he lost to us.
We going
1-1, nigga. We beat y'all two times last year. Don't be talking to me.
Nigga, last year.
Yes.
The year after that.
Can we get
1-1.
The year before that?
1-1.
Yo.
After that, I don't know.
Macho, man. You yelling.
All right, bro. Come on. I'm hot.
I know. Because you yelling and jumping and shit.
I'm hot.
Hey,
bro, this is how we usually be, bro. Chill out.
Lamont not even good at Madden.
Perfect time to enter in this motherfucker. Hey, you know I'm back in this bitch.
Here we go.
In this bitch, but a lot more.
That's another episode of. Oh, shit. Hey,
you know what
Go ahead, Asa. What's up, man? Where you been? You been taking a shit.
Taking a shit.
I'm back in this motherfucker.
Hey, Asa, why are you
Protein. Hey, look, hey, look, hey, look, you know that.
Damn,
that
why are these niggas yelling in my fucking ears?
Hey, look, look, hey, look.
This nigga is yelling.
Hey, yo, hey, yo, hey, yo, hey, yo.
This nigga yelling? You just
been not yelling,
yelling.
Bro.
Hey,
yo,
hey, you can't be yelling.
Hey, hey, real talk, bro. I really want to talk about this money.
Come on. I love the money.
Let's talk about this money. You feel me?
What money?
Let's talk about what's going on in cryptocurrency.
You going to have to inform me, pimp. Go ahead.
What? I mean, you're yelling in crypto?
I don't need people seeing my son. Hey Juju, you lied though, boy.
How's that? You in crypto?
What is that?
Baby steps.
Cryptocurrency is like the stock market. The Ethereum one. I got some of that.
Oh my dog! I promise you. Hey, look,
Ethereum 2.0 finna go crazy. Or it is.
Put us on
crazy.
Game, bro. Let's put us on game.
Basically, Ethereum is a second biggest cryptocurrency out there.
Okay.
It has the biggest potential because it has the ability to recreate the internet.
I'm downloading that shit right now.
I already been on game, nigga. Go to Coinbase. You know what I'm saying? Go to Coinbase right now, and then you can buy Ethereum. It's probably the safest network you have because it is on the stock market right now. So if you are in the stock market, go ahead and buy Coinbase because it's finna go up. Cryptocurrency finna go crazy, y'all. Hey, look, let me tell you about this, what's happening. What y'all need to do right now when y'all hit it big, because I know a lot of you guys that are going to be watching this are in cryptocurrency. Go ahead and open up an LLC. Plan for it. Because what happens every 4 years?
What happens?
It goes up. So, when it first opened up, what was the years? Fudge crackers. Look, look, look. I don't have that information right in front of me, but I promise you, whoever started in Bitcoin back when it first started. Oh, my bad, bro.
Not you. Just like a little
Oh, okay. Well, Lamont. Where are you?
In the Gidget scarf.
Oh, you already looking handsome as shit. Look at him. No. Pause. Let's say that right there.
You can say all this.
I want my girl to be feminine.
Hey, can we talk about that? Why is my girl to be feminine?
Yo, that nigga look handsome as shit over there. Though.
Hey, I'm just having my man.
Why is that a pause? Can we talk about that?
Pause.
What is pause?
Why is calling your homeboy handsome a pause?
Because I just don't want the viewers to think that any type of way. You know what I'm saying? I'm for sure straight, but I'm just hyping
handsome,
my man's up.
I call
all y'all niggas handsome.
That's my brother. You know what I'm saying? So I gotta.
I call all y'all niggas that are handsome.
So all the ladies that are actually ladies. As you guys view this,
huh?
You handsome, bro.
Okay. Hey, Javon is handsome than a motherfucker. For sure.
I'm a bad kid.
That's a whole nother subject.
Hey, look, pause. All my guys are handsome. Even Ayo.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
so, look. Pause.
Now, if I could.
Let me explain myself.
Now, if I could.
Why?
I'm
gonna
let it slide.
Why you say EAO like that, bro?
No, not even. Look, I knew y'all was gonna say something, so I was gonna prepare to explain myself after that. You know what I'm saying? I was the last person that was in the camera that I was gonna mention. So it was no malice or bad intent with that. You know what I'm saying? Real talk, even though y'all trying to make it seem like I'm, you know, singing my nigga out. You know what I'm saying? That's not the case at all.
You
singing
him out, nigga?
Real talk.
Get the point. Come on.
Hey.
I'm good.
So, Javon. Look. My man is really handsome, and I'll tell you that.
Bro, get off me! God damn! Go to the next.
Oh, okay. So don't talk about how Javon is handsome.
Javon,
bro, talk about how he handsome.
Oh, Ayo,
bro, we good, bro.
Okay.
What the fuck?
You know, I'll point out some traits for you, ladies. if y'all really looking to fix.
Hey, so all right. What I've been talking to y'all lately in the episodes is about, okay. We got to do a mobile episode. I need to see Asa in a couple of different situations. Mm-hmm. One, with female.
I bet.
Mic'd up.
What are we doing?
That's why we're here. We're brainstorming. Mic'd up. I need to see that. Okay. I need to see Asa in a business meeting because I need to know how he talks. Because if he talk like this, if he don't talk like this, it's a front.
I know how he is. I've been in business.
I also think this is just one of Ace's personalities. I think this is also a facade.
He's schizo?
Whoa. Guys, let's calm it down. Ladies, do not listen to him. If you're watching this, follow me on IG at Ace of Taylor.
He switched. It's underscore. Two different niggas in you there. I just heard it.
Yo. I promise you, I'll give you the best dick of your life.
Yo!
I promise you, I'll dick you down and break your
My heart. Nigga, ayo! Whoa! You're whispering in my ear. You're not talking to no ladies, nigga. It's five niggas with headphones on.
My bad.
Like, what are you talking about?
My bad. I was really addressing the camera.
That shit.
You nigga said,
if you're Latina.
This nigga weird.
If you're Latina, if you're European, if you're Asian.
Bro, I felt that shit on my neck.
If you're Pacific Islander, I promise you, I will binge you the fuck over.
Hey, yo, shut the fuck up.
I'm sorry, guys. What are we talking about?
See, this is my. Come here, bro.
Wait a second. Guys, camera. Stop pissing. Camera. Do y'all see this? Right now I'm about to get abused. This is what I go through on a daily basis, guys.
Wait a second. Guys.
Nah, really, how are they talking, bro? All
right,
man. Yeah, you lead the mic. Don't pull them.
Bro, wait, why are you pulling me over here, bro? Wait, bro.
What did I miss?
We can talk about what
happened, bro. Why are you talking about why it's okay to call your niggas handsome?
Oh yeah, and then definitely.
Started getting beat.
Shut up! We're not.
Oh shit!
Oh yeah.
So it's definitely okay to call your man's handsome.
Javon, get your hands off of him!
No. Okay.
You can't touch him.
Yo, y'all gotta stop doing this. Y'all gotta.
Yo, eventually Ace is gonna have a hive, bro.
It's me.
And when Ace has his hive, they're gonna attack you. You can't do this.
Who gonna attack me?
Stop putting your hands on that man. I wish a nigga would. For Ace to put the goons on you.
Look.
What goons?
I was just...
I really ain't hands to goon, nigga, so what goon?
I'm really just saying that it's okay to call your man's handsome because at the end of the day, you never know who's watching. You know what I'm saying? And you want to be supportive of your man's. It's not gay at all. You know what I'm saying? I know it's how some of y'all are thinking out there, but understand something.
Is he high?
If...
What the fuck he think about?
Are you talking about Elliot?
Nah, this nigga.
What did he say? Because he said, what the fuck did he just say?
I just said it's definitely okay to call your man handsome.
Okay. Man, go ahead.
So.
I'm done with this nigga, bro. You got this motherfucker, bro. That's your nigga now.
Wait a second. Time out.
Oh, God.
Why are you passing me around like a whore?
Because you are a whore.
Okay, I understand. Look. I get that.
You gotta relax.
I have no problem being a slut. Okay. Look,
I was gonna.
You don't be fucking shit.
Jamal, hold on.
No.
Jamal, hold on.
Wait a second.
Hold on.
Asa, are we talking about
my sex life?
Asa,
yeah.
Hold on. In my ear, and I want you to know, I don't appreciate a grown man muttering shit like that in my ear.
Yeah, I apologize.
There's okay, five black men with headphones on. Yeah. There ain't no females with headphones on.
Nah, I
can feel you talking. I don't like feeling you talk.
Nah, I'm not gonna let you feel me.
Oh shit.
That nigga talk anxious. No. Nah.
Bitch, you gassing this shit too. Bro, shut your ass up. Stop gassing this shit. Yeah.
You guys. Okay, come on, bro. Let's get it. Come on.
That's what I'm saying, man. Next subject. Go ahead.
God damn it. Come on, Ace. Get it.
And we clipping all that out.
Yes, we definitely are clipping that out.
No, we don't get the bitch in there.
I'm definitely not whispering in my mind.
I agree with you saying, though. I have no problem calling my niggas handsome, like, bro. We all put a couple of sexuality. Like,
how far do y'all take no homo?
I mean, I don't say no homo when I'm with my nigga. I don't say no homo when I'm with my
nigga. What do you mean, how far?
Bro, like what warrants a no homo?
Time out. I got some.
Because you know how we play, Joe Marcus.
Well, how y'all play?
No, no.
How y'all
niggas
play, bro?
Guys, let's do this. Pause. Have a great subject.
Pause. Hard pause, nigga.
There it goes.
As we start transitioning and everything like that, you guys probably won't want to answer this, but when you guys were single and ready to mingle. Why do you think that women would, what was the main reason that women would flake on you for?
Flake?
Flake. Like not show up to dates and stuff like
I've
that.
Never had that happen.
But Jamon, you're 6'4", 260.
Okay. Don't ask the nigga the question if he can't answer.
Why did you just bring up his measurements?
He does it every episode.
I mean, he's black. He's 6'4".
Okay, answer the question, man. I have never had a woman flick on me, so.
So you've never had no one not show up for the date?
No.
I've had someone not show up, but people genuinely get busy. It's not always because, like, don't take everything personal. Like,
what? Are we talking about, like, a planned date? Yes. Yeah. Like out somewhere, not to the crib or nothing like that.
Yeah. Oh, wait a second. Both of them. I would say in this day and age,
I don't think I've had nobody flake on me on a planned date. Like movies, dinner, club.
Have people flaked on you, Asa?
Yes.
Okay, so what happened?
You don't think you should change your ways?
No.
True. Okay. What happened?
I told bitch to come through.
Or to the crib?
I told that bitch to
the crib?
Yes, to the crib, to out to eat, not out to eat, but out for drinks. You don't never take a woman out to eat on the first date, guys. Let's be clear. In today's day and age, she's gonna expect a lot out of you. Don't ever do that, gentlemen. Guys,
listen.
Beware of these 304s out here. A lot of these thoughts are expecting handouts. Don't do it until they give you the box first. You need the box first, and then you can actually figure out what type of person she is.
I'm crying. I got
tears. Go ahead. All
right. So you saying don't take her out on a date until you fuck?
Yes. You can take her out for drinks or coffee. That's it.
That's a date.
That's not. I mean. It's not necessarily a date. It's just
no. It's
so you can't take a female out to dinner unless you fuck.
And fuck her first, and then you can take her out to dinner.
Fuck her first, then take her out to dinner.
But until why then, take her out first for coffee all, or drinks.
Why is that?
Because you want to keep that investment low. Because guess what, women like to do? They like to go out with men they don't or they are not sexually attracted to, and see what they can get.
How many?
So
how many?
I promise you, if you ask any woman in the world how many dates she's been on that she's not sexually attracted to the guy, I promise you, every woman would say she has been out on a date with a man she's not sexually attracted to. I promise you.
Okay, time out. So how many people have you fucked on the first day?
Not even a date.
On the first time you met them, like I'm attracted to you, motherfucker. Like let me fuck.
Very low.
I felt that. I felt that. We had the moments, man.
3 to 5.
Nigga said,
3 to 5 people you fucked on the first day. Be like, hey, I'm gonna try to tell you, I'm on the fuck. Come let me fuck. Let me fuck.
Yeah, 3 to 5.
I ain't gonna lie, you should be low on that. Your stats should be low unless you
on the first day type shit.
On the first day,
here's the thing. If you give up the box on the first day, I promise you, I give you more time. But if you make me wait I promise you, I'm going to bend you over and go.
I hate when motherfuckers be like, bro, you can't give out the pussy because the nigga ain't going to respect you.
Nigga, what?
I'm like, bro, what?
Nigga, what?
I'm definitely going to respect you the day.
Hey, you on camera with that room up.
Give up that motherfucking box. Give up that motherfucking box. Because I promise you, a man of
value
and a man of means will bend you over.
Let me see what that pussy feel like. The first day before I waste my time with your motherfucking
come
ass.
Come on now, talk your shit.
If it's good, you know, average, I leave. Then motherfucker, we keep on going.
It ain't got to be a 10 out of 10, but if it's at least a 6 or a 7, come on now.
And you can suck some dick? Head?
Oh!
Have you ever had a bad egg?
Hold on.
I didn't say bad head. I said a bad egg, as in like bad sex.
Yes.
I think
everybody's
had bad sex before.
I think like once, bro. I'm not going to lie to you.
I only had it once, too.
Oh. What?
No, twice. It was
okay. That makes sense. That makes sense for you. I mean,
bitch, that makes sense. Don't speak on me.
That makes sense. I mean, like,
smoke weed every day.
We're not.
I mean, ayo. I mean, like, you haven't only bad sex one time.
One time, dog.
Damn, that's crazy. I had bad sex about man, 8 to 10 times.
8 to 10.
Nigga, it's you.
What the fuck?
It's gotta be him.
Nah.
Somebody know what
to the 40.
Hey, whoa! Hey, we cut that part out. We cut 40. That part out.
Keep it in.
Put it on here.
Hey, look. Lamont, he said 40.
Keep it in.
4-0.
4-0.
Wait. What are you cutting up?
20 plus 20.
40-0.
What's the percentage? Okay, what's the math on that? 40 to 8. So 8 bad.
That's like at least motherfucking. That's like 18%, nigga.
18%. We'll go with that.
Look, no, it's like I'm tripping.
Look, guys, like understand this. I'm operating at fucking bitches at a lower level, so there's tiers to this shit. First tier, second tier, third tier, and fourth tier. First tier is one.
Why is your pussy so bad though?
You haven't been here.
Her pH levels be out because she be drinking fucking whiskey.
Mastered the ones, the twos.
Hey, her pH levels are off.
Hold on, Asa, hold on.
No, I'm not fucking a one.
Wait, Lamont, let me catch you up.
He be fucking 1, 2, and 3s.
He said he's mastered the 1s and the 2s, and he's the conquering the 3s right now.
He's working the 4s and 5s. 3s, 4s, and 5s right now.
What's a 1, Lamont?
What's a one?
I don't think I've seen one, nigga.
Fucking a one.
What is a one?
Trailer Park White Trash.
Why you fucking Trailer Park?
Sometimes when you need
I've had Trailer Park pussy that wasn't no one.
One time when you need your dick wet, yeah, you just gotta pick that bitch over.
Who have you had?
Hold on. First of all, Jovan, me and you used to live in a trailer. Let's not act like
what bitches. What bitches did we fuck?
I didn't say we fucked bitches.
So I never had Trailer Park pussy.
What I'm saying is just because you live in a trailer don't make you dirty.
I can't nothing.
Oh, for
that's what I'm saying.
What does a one look like? Y'all are still skipping over this.
One titty, seven toes. Six fingers in.
So you fucking that?
let me
you fucking that?
Hey, so can you show us? Can you show us a couple?
No,
of ones?
Not even.
No,
bro, beat your meat, nigga.
One is not your last.
Beat your meat and go to sleep.
Beat your dick.
Yes.
Beat your meat and go to sleep,
bro.
I am not going to.
Okay, so understand this. Okay, so can we all agree? Oh, I mean,
he mastered the ones. Why would you want to master ones though?
Because
master
ones.
You're supposed to accidentally.
I was born. No, then you accidentally hit a one. Stop saying it.
Wait, bro, hold on, going to.
Joke. Yo,
nigga.
This nigga say the last resort. Accidentally, no, bro.
Jovan, I'm trying to get him. Jovan, don't help him out. You never fucked a one in your life. I don't care.
You have never fucked a one.
He knows.
You have never fucked a one. I ain't never fucked a one.
You never fucked a one in your life. I don't think he's fucked a one.
I
but
definitely
you know what a one is?
But I don't know what a one is.
Hey, is it cool if I name drop on you?
Go ahead.
No, name drop.
No.
Just show us.
No.
I want a name.
Cool. You know what I'm saying? I'm a gentleman in all things I do.
You can show a picture.
Let me see.
I'm a gentleman in all things I do. But I will say it off camera.
What's the one?
Show us.
Who?
You know it.
Who?
I can't say it because the mics are on. But just know. Wait a second. Understand that a one is Trailer Park, whiskey drinking,
okay,
cheap liquor.
Oh, see this mother.
pH levels balanced
listen,
it
listen,
off.
Listen.
I'm talking about.
Hey, sir, hold on.
Wait a second.
I'm talking about crack, baby.
He said crack.
She does drugs.
Yo, I'm weak.
You fucked that. Hey, so what is wrong with you?
Sometimes we
you
need some pussy.
You ain't never fucked a girl that do drugs?
But he didn't never say it in a way. But time out. He didn't never say
are we talking?
Any unattractive.
That bitch going heroin, nigga.
If it's needles, I ain't fucking with it.
But he still didn't
see,
say
bro.
Physical features.
See,
Asa.
You gotta step. See, that's why I stepped outside my boundaries, nigga.
Time out.
I didn't say no physical features, though.
But when it's thrown in your face like that, you feel me? I mean, when I was a young kid.
You also just told me you wouldn't fuck Brittany Renner if she walked up to you.
So no, she's a 304.
But she'll fuck up.
He said Brittany Renner's a 304.
Brittany Renner's a 304.
I mean, they all 304s, but you gotta understand the difference between a 304 and a Brittany Renner.
Brittany Renner. She's definitely like an 8.
Brittany Renner?
Would you fuck Brittany Renner?
Yes.
Nigga, you tripping.
Yeah,
talking to me, man.
You tripping.
You're not even listening.
You tripping.
After that mindset, hell nah. You motherfucker.
Why just based off of looks? I just say I have a personality.
Based off of looks, nigga. You're not that guy.
Look, Brittany Renner, she look good, but understand something.
If you didn't know her background, would you fuck that woman?
No. Look, I know her background now.
No
see,
context.
The fuck.
Asa, please be objective with me. Please.
I'm trying to be objective.
You just see a picture of this woman. Would you fuck that woman?
If I don't know her background?
Yes.
I'm going to do research on her.
What the fuck this nigga?
If you don't got no Wi-Fi, you don't got no computer, you don't got no books, you don't got nothing.
I got hotspot.
You don't got no hotspot either.
It's a hotspot.
You at the club.
Every woman you see,
you at the club. You see her
you
ass
see that
right
person.
There.
And she all on your dick, nigga.
Your phone in the car. The internet's not working in the club.
Listen to me. Any nigga that told me he mastered the ones is fucking Brittany Renner.
For sure.
Stop listening to this.
For a fact.
For me, guys, just because she had a fat ass don't mean she can get my dick.
Nigga, she look good. Nigga, fuck the ass. Nigga, she look good.
Without makeup, she's like 6 at best.
You just said
you just mastered ones.
No, I did not.
Get your mans, bro.
I'm about to flip all this show over.
So she's a 6 at best without makeup. And I'm being generous with her because I think I said she was
Tiana
a 5
Trump.
Last time.
That's her best
cool.
friend. He close as fuck to the
Tiana Trump.
Tiana Trump, I've definitely been her the fuck over.
I don't think she's that attractive.
Tiana Trump is not that attractive.
Tiana Trump is definitely, she can definitely get the dick.
I ain't gonna lie.
Because she know what to do with that shit. Hey, look. She can definitely get the dick.
Tiana Trump.
Tiana Trump can get the dick, you feel me? Hey,
she.
Hey, look. Hey, y'all heard of Kiki Club?
So, what
did he say?
He had
8 or 9. Yo, mic is not working. But anyways, so like I was saying, I mastered the 1s, 2s, and 3s. Now I'm on to the 4s, 5s. And 6s are going to be coming. But 6s.
Why did you master the 1s?
Why did I master the 1s?
What was the purpose?
Because I just want to know I can bend them the fuck over.
A 1?
The 3. A 1. I just need to know. I just need that validation.
So
because
you have a dominance thing, like. Now, I don't want to say complex because that makes it seem like something bad, but you have to have dominance.
Yes, at all times. I have to be. I have to be.
Was that answering you?
You know your mic is not working. I
know. Lamont's not either.
The what?
That's fine. You be spitting in people's mouths when you have sex. Try to take the mic out. Spitting in mouths?
Lamont asked. So the question is spitting in women's mouth when he has sex.
I don't spit in women's mouths, but I do.
You a nasty nigga.
I don't spit in women's mouths.
Nasty nigga.
But if I'm with you.
And I know you.
Hey, they like it though.
You feel me?
They like it. It is what it is.
Hey, if they like it, she getting bit the fuck over. Hey, but listen.
That just made my stomach hurt.
Shit, let's go down the fucking list then. Who eating ass in this motherfucker?
You know I'm eating ass in this motherfucker. Come on. Hey, look. You eating ass too?
Don't touch his knuckle.
Oh, yeah. Hey, look. That's going to make your beard grow even better. Hey, Jovan, I know you eat ass.
No, nigga.
Jovan for sure eat ass.
Why the fuck you Tay?
What is Tay?
What does Tay stand for?
One of the personalities.
Tay means the ass eater.
Come on.
So if you pass the test and you'll be with me, and after you get out the shower, definitely going to eat your
right
ass.
Straight out the shower and shit.
Straight out the shower.
Straight out the gym.
Because I know for a fact that's going to make
the
you.
Right off.
I know for sure that's going to make you bust, and that's going to make you squirt. And guess what? After you squirt,
I'm right off the bench. Okay, look. Right off the squat machine.
Stop it, because if I go in detail, it's gonna be disgusting. You feel me?
How many girls you made squirt for?
What's up? How many girls you made? Lamont!
How many girls have you made squirt for? Yo, what the fuck going on?
Honestly?
Come on.
The last 25 girls I've been with, I've made squirt. 25.
Yo! He's happy!
He said the last 25 he made squirt.
The last 25.
Every girl I've been with, I've made squirt recently.
So the last girls you fucked, you just got.
Yes, because my dick and my tongue game is that good.
And they all squirted.
King Dingling, yes. Nigga. Fuck is you talking?
Hey, look, I'm gonna just keep it a stack.
Pause on everything I'm about to say. Actually,
you know 25 squirters like that?
I don't know 25 bitches that can squirt.
Stop the cap. Because bitches be telling me all the time, I don't squirt.
25 for 25.
I don't squirt.
That's what I'm saying.
No, I'm not 25 for 25 at any means. But I will say, I said the last 25 bitches I've been with, I've made squirt. So at some level, either if it's with my dick or if it's with my tongue, I'm baiting on squirt. Now understand this. I need you guys to please understand. Elliot. Hold on, now I'm about to go off on this motherfucker. Nah, hey, y'all, shit. Understand this, y'all.
Talk your shit, kid.
A woman always can say she doesn't squirt, but once you hit that spot, it's a wrap, nigga. All you gotta do is hit, with your tongue, hit that clit 5 to 10 minutes.
Bitch, I'm tired.
15 minutes at max.
15 minutes.
Nigga, don't matter. Hey, look, you getting your jaw getting a workout. You better get used to that shit. Because I promise you, you hit that shit for 15 minutes, she gonna squirt. She gonna squirt. You hit her G spot. You hit her G spot, which is at the top of the vagina. You hit that G spot with your dick. I promise you, she's gonna make her squirt.
Hey, so I'm a grown ass man, bro.
You know that.
So why are you talking?
So you know that. On God, right?
I need a mic, nigga.
So you know that, right? Jamon.
It's just crazy. You had 25 consecutive squirters.
Understand something.
Your nigga's Klay Thompson.
Nigga, understand something. You start off with your ABCs.
He ain't even dribble.
A.
I spell my name in that.
B.
Oh, shit.
C.
Hey, yo, we about to end the podcast.
Understand.
Stop. Stop before I hit your forehead.
So, what is the lesson that we learned here today?
Don't do that.
Not to ask you certain questions.
Because I will go in detail now.
But listen, hold on. You went off way off shit, bro. So we said the last 8 or 9 of your females been dicks, right? You said they flaked on you.
Yeah. So what's well, I mean, why is
so
that important?
Why, I'm asking.
why you bring that back up and shit?
Why is that important?
Why do they flake on you?
Yeah, why do you think?
Because I'm not 264, 260.
Lamont's not 6'4", 260. Bro, he thinks y'all are the 1%. Me and Ace had this conversation all the time.
Lamont is definitely the 1%.
Lamont's a 1%er.
He definitely is.
Your size doesn't do it. It's about confidence, how you carry yourself.
It is, but it's also about the attributes that attract you to women.
Definitely help, but that's not the.
Wait a second. Privilege is blind to those that have it. Privilege is blind to those that have it. Privilege is blind to those that have it.
You got to let them speak.
Privilege is blind to those that have it. Can we agree on that?
Fuck the camera. Fuck the camera. Look.
Is that facts?
What's the question?
That's a good point. What's the question?
So when you have privilege, you don't understand what the average man goes through because you're 6'1". How much you weigh? About 200 pounds. Javon's 6'4", 260. So any
6'4", 260.
Yo, he's not LeBron James, bro. You
six,
gotta stop describing 6'4",
250. I'm sorry.
This thing is 220.
So he's very selective. If you look at any woman in the world, what they want is a man over 6'3" that just looks the part that can dick them down. Now, if you look like you can dick them down and you look like you're willing and able and you have a mouthpiece,
look at me, Javon, so there. I can see if I see what he's talking about.
Yo, you ain't got.
Look at me.
Now,
you know.
Realistically speaking,
look at me. So realistically speaking,
only a certain percentage of the population is over 6 foot, and only a certain percentage of the world is over 6'3". So, with you,
I have a lot of short niggas, a lot of niggas under 6 foot, who's about 150. Dicking bitches down.
Yes, that's very true.
That has a more of a list than me.
Yes,
so,
that's very true.
Okay.
And that can happen.
Okay.
At the same time, women are automatically attracted to you, not based off your mouthpiece, but based off your attributes.
It's based off the scribbles on your arm.
Is what you're basically
I'm basically saying you're
it's
a sex symbol.
It's because they be trying to read the tattoo on his arm.
What does that say? Oh, my God. So, with that being said.
My nigga right here don't. No,
it don't. Okay. Lamont is still over 6 foot. Lamont's over 6 foot.
Bring somebody up, man. You nigga who?
My nigga,
this nigga feds.
My nigga,
this nigga.
One of my other niggas ain't got no tattoos whatsoever.
Just name him Kyle.
Kyle. What's up, Kyle?
What's up?
Shout out to my nigga Kyle.
Call him Kyle.
He ain't got no tattoos at all.
But what I do understand what Ace is talking about. You do fit the aesthetic.
I understand it, but fuck it.
It's not about fuck it. It's about seeing what. So like I said to Lamont.
Look, bro, like, all that can go through. Like,
so like,
there's niggas that are shorter than me. They got more bodies than me.
So like I said, the exception don't make the rule. I said that last time. But now you guys, like, how tall are you? 6'1". You're 6'1". Most women look for men over 6 foot with a 6-pack abs that are tall that
I
make
got
money.
A belly, boy.
They don't know if you have 6-pack. You take a shot out, so that's
out the window. That you can cap. No. Stop it. Because cap. Stop it, Lamont. We're not gonna do this. We're not gonna do this right now. because we all know what attracts women. So we're not gonna play this fucking game right now.
Oh shit!
But what we are gonna do?
What attracts?
No. Wait a second. Because we don't have to have women in the podcast because I already know what they're attracted to. Period. They don't need to be in this hole. I know what it attracts you because at the end of the day, I've been around enough women and I study women enough to know that.
You've only been around the one.
So,
you know
everything I've been
around the one.
Attraction is not universal, Jason.
Why you always lying?
Bro, I can't take your word on that because you've been around the ones and the twos and the threes, my nigga.
And where are teens at?
Teens are only privileged if you pay. Teens are only available if you pay for it, my nigga.
Oh fuck.
Oh shit. Teens are only available. I don't give a fuck who you are.
Oh shit.
I don't give a fuck who you are. Teens are only available if you pay for it.
Oh fuck.
In what way?
Y'all niggas pay. Javon, you paying?
In every way.
Lamont, you paying?
Would you pay for
this?
Listen. No more incriminating yourself, sir.
Listen.
Would you? Would you pay for pussy financially? Not with your time, not with anything else. Would you pay for pussy?
Yes.
You.
To each his own.
Oh, I don't have to. No.
I ain't never had to.
I don't need to.
You. Guys, would I?
Lamont.
Yes or no?
Lamont.
We letting the audience know. We know, but the audience don't know. Okay. Bet. Elliot,
who is the right here? You. He has the bubble. At the end of the day, if I see a bitch, that's a 10.
She gotta pay me.
Oh shit, he's selling dick.
Eddie's selling dick.
That nigga selling dick.
I would do that before I
paid for something. Me, Eddie selling dick.
We about to wrap this up soon.
Hey, look, she gotta be of a certain class and a certain stature. So she for sure gotta be Latina or Arabian.
That's not a class or a stature.
She got
bro, that's not a class or a stature.
How much would you pay for pussy though?
It just depends on how fine she is.
Why the fuck you lying? Why you always?
It's like your dream girl, whatever the fuck she look like. Some it's bullshit. Your dream girl. Some bullshit.
I mean,
but it's your dream girl.
She Argentinian. Venezuelan. Hold on, Venezuela?
And she mixed with Venezuela.
Hold on, bro.
And she speaks Spanish, her first language. Yeah.
Stop playing with me.
How much would you pay for it?
And she call you Poppy.
How much would she pay? And she call you Poppy, dude.
Oh, fuck.
That Poppy
God
shit.
Damn.
Hey, yo, that Poppy.
Nigga, wait. Hey, bro, you just gonna leave me hanging, bro, on the camera?
That Poppy shit.
Oh, shit. Okay, I appreciate it.
It gotta be a real one.
And look, she gotta be for real.
White girl call you Poppy?
No.
No.
You ever had a white girl call you nigga?
Nigga?
Well, cut this part out. She's getting punished. She's definitely getting handcuffed.
How much did you pay for pussy, nigga?
I don't know what the industry standard is, so I can't speak on that.
Nigga, how much would you pay?
What's your maximum?
What's your max on paying for pussy?
It just depends on what role I'm playing.
Why the fuck you lying?
Yo,
right now.
What?
This, hey, right this is the last question. This right nigga now. Bugging.
Answer the question.
Right now.
You
should stop being so hard.
That's a good question. Kind of question for you guys. Why aren't you paying for pussy?
I don't need to.
Because at the end of the day, men like variety. If we're being honest, we need options.
I got it for it, though.
What does that have to do with paying for it? Variety and options has nothing to do with paying
for
it.
So, we pay for privacy.
Hold on, listen. If I was single, I could have options at no cost. So why pay for pussy? So, why pay for pussy?
Because of the time. Sometimes you're not going to have time to go out and game bitches.
I got time.
You got time.
I'm gonna find something, bro.
You got time.
I got time.
Until I have time, yes, I'm gonna pay for box.
That's it. Hey, yo.
You know, fuck that beat.
I'm on the
beat.
You ain't getting
no. Sing it through the headphones.
You gonna get an ounce of pussy?
And that's another episode of
you. Hey, if she's a Christian, better. Oh my God, them Christian bitches be freaky than a motherfucker. I'm talking about sucking your dick from the back, y'all.
My nigga, you in my ear with this shit. Let me find this song so we can end this shit.
I apologize. You know, I was trying to keep it respectful, but Eddie and Javon started me on this shit. It's Eddie and Javon's fault.
Hey, yo, Asa, say your last words, bro. Go ahead.
Last words, shout out to Holiday, shout out to AO, shout out to E Mills, shout out to Javon, shout out to Eric, shout out to Ramon, shout out to all.
Shout out, happy birthday, Ramon, happy birthday,
happy
Ramon.
Fucking happy birthday, birthday, Ramon. Happy birthday, Ramon. I promise you, bro, do your fucking thing. Happy fucking birthday, bro. Keep grinding. I promise you, you got people looking up to you, bro.
Yeah, I'm coming.
I promise
in
you, yo. So, I gotta go after this because I got some business. All right,
I'm gonna play
this
new West Side Gun.
Hell yeah.
Backseat of the Rolls Royce. Screaming money ain't a thing in my whole voice. I had to get rich, they left me no choice. It weigh a little extra cause the dope noise.